be running after you. It's like chasing the clouds. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm, and time is frozen. The story of my life, I give her love. I spend her love until she's broken.
Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's time to wake up and let the weirdness begin.
It's the KBJ show.
So start your morning.
Kevin is the host.
And his skin pigment is whiter than Casper the Ghost.
Virginia.
Sounds like this.
Nickname Vicious Beast.
So don't get her pissed.
It's Jason. Talks like a spaz.
And they love to talk about Bigfoot and stacks. So get ready. Here we go. You're listening to 97.9 with the KBJ show.
Yeah, baby. Hello and welcome to the Friday KBJ show. How the heck is everybody?
Hello.
Yeah.
Happy Woo-hoo. Friday.
Oh, man. So fired up for it. Gonna be a good little weekend here. Got a lot of stuff going on here today. It is the start of sea turtle nesting season.
Aww.
So if you go out to one of our lovely beaches here in South Florida this weekend, just be aware that the sea turtles are going to start their nesting. So do not disturb the nest. You'll see the flags all over the beach. Don't be like, hey, what's in the middle of this? Let's dig.
Don't no, do that. Don't touch them.
Don't do that.
If you could really interview a turtle and really get inside the mind, are they happy being a turtle? Do they like that lifestyle? Very slow moving.
That's all they know, man.
I know.
That's all they know. I'd be like, I don't know anything else. It's just what I do.
Do they look at, you know, other animals and go, gosh, I really would like to run like a rabbit?
I
wish I was a tiger.
You think a sea turtle sees many rabbits?
I don't know. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Probably
I'm
not. Yeah.
What's a day in the life of a sea turtle?
Does a turtle look at a shark and go, damn, he's got it going on?
And does a shark look at a turtle and go, oh, delicious. Oh, yeah. That dang shell.
Turtle soup.
Just nature right there. Today's also the National Day of Unplugging.
Ah. Oh, I love that.
Uh-huh.
That kind of goes with what's on my mind a little bit.
Okay. All right. Well, you're going to be topical then. It's National Employee Appreciation Day. And it's also National Peanut Butter Lovers Day.
Ooh.
Who loves peanut butter? You guys fans of peanut butter?
We
love
do.
It. Had peanut butter pie earlier this week.
Oh, man. Okay. So we got a lot of things to celebrate here on the Friday KBJ show. Coming up here, we're going to get into the minds of what all we have going on here. Lots of things to talk about, including lots of events happening this weekend in South Florida. We're going to break it all down for you so you're not left out in the cold. That is all coming up on the KBJ show.
can't sleep until I feel your touch.
What are you thinking about? What are you thinking about?
What's on your mind?
Are you thinking about? What are you thinking about?
All right, Jay Byrne. It's National Unplugging Day, and you said that kind of has something to do with what you got on your mind today.
Yes, tech rage. Unplugging from just the technical world. I have seen two people in the last week that I know fly off the handle because of tech issues, and I can relate to it. I, too, suffer from tech rage. I'm kind of proud of myself, though. Last night, we had some technical issues with Weird and Whatever. At the 50-minute mark, it kicked us off the internet.
Oh.
And I didn't get tech rage. I got tech sadness.
Yeah.
So if you... I don't think the good people could hear the end of the podcast. When we re-upload it, you're going to hear me at the end kind of just going, I don't know why this keeps happening. So you'll hear a little tech sadness. Good news is, though, we did figure out the problem, so that was a positive.
Okay.
But because so many people are suffering from it, here's what many articles are saying you should do if you suffer from tech rage. First thing they say is walk away from the computer for 15 minutes just to cool off. And as I'm reading this tech rage article, I started getting rage about the ways to fix your tech rage. It made me upset because they were kind of stupid.
Okay.
They were just basic things that everyone knows anyway.
Yeah, it really wasn't a lot of wealth of knowledge in that, huh?
Back up your work, duh.
Yeah. Thanks.
Don't skip on security. Replace your hardware before it breaks. Use your support network. Support networks suck. They're not very supportive.
No. Is that where you have to call somebody, or is it somewhere you go online?
Well,
or
now,
a bit of both?
Sometimes now they make you stay online. You can't. If you call, they direct you right to be talking to an AI robot.
Oh, my.
Which, if you have a specific problem with an issue, they don't know what you're talking about. So they'll go, oh, yeah, why don't you call?
And then this
you call.
One.
Then it goes, why don't you go to the
website?
Let me
connect you to this one. Then they connect you and they're like, oh no, I can't help you with that. That's not my deal. That's happened to me several times.
I felt really bad for this one guy that I know because he was about to get his work done and send it off. And I guess it just got lost.
We've all
experienced that before.
Oh, that's tough.
Raise your hand here on the show if you've suffered from tech rage.
Oh, Very much so.
Yeah,
yes.
I'm hitting all my phone. I abuse it.
Do you do anything to make yourself feel better? Because they say walk away from the computer for 15 minutes. A lot of times the tech rage becomes a thing because you are on a deadline on something.
That's the problem with it. Great advice, but then what do I tell my boss or the situation where it's like, okay, I got to have something done.
Right, I'm not surfing the internet for fun.
Right, and that's usually what's driving it. I have the pressure to have a certain project done by a certain amount of time, and then everything goes... And then what do? You walk in here and you're like, hey, guys, we got nothing to talk about today. And all right, suck it.
I do feel stupid, though, when I get mad at technology.
Yeah, I do, too, because I realize, man, if you had a camera on me and you played it back, man, just look how stupid you look.
There have been times alone in my house where I go, if there was a camera. There's been times in front of people. I go, I don't think they like me anymore.
Mm-hmm, I hear what you're saying.
I remember when you were so close to getting a TikTok video done, Virginia. All you had to do was hit post, and you lost it forever.
It disappeared.
She had a meltdown.
Yeah.
I have a meltdown a lot about tech stuff because you're learning as you go. And that's the thing. You're going to make mistakes. And sometimes those mistakes have just cost you hours of work.
It's the mistakes that I don't understand. When something's working one way and then all of a sudden there's some kind of weird anomaly and it doesn't work, you go, universe, what the heck, man?
Why me?
Mm-hmm. But I'll tell you what, though. Watch me on the other end watching somebody go through tech rage. It was uncomfortable and not fun to watch.
Yeah. Virginia, what you got on your mind today?
I feel, kind of piggybacking off what you're talking about, tech stuff, I feel like maybe I have that popcorn brain you were talking about the other day.
Yes.
And I'm trying to figure out what this new sensory issue I have is I feel it in my brain. I feel it in my body. I feel it's like a low vibration that I didn't have before that has given me not a lot of patience. I have to be multitasking at all times. I feel like I can't do one thing. I've got to be doing multiple things, but then nothing gets done properly.
So you recognize that you're doing it wrong, but you can't stop yourself from doing it wrong.
I think I have to really make more of a concerted effort, and I have to just decide, okay, I'm not going to try to multitask. I'm going to try to do one thing and stop this hum, this buzz in my head that is making me want to, you know, while I'm watching TV, I'm scrolling through Instagram looking for show ideas. Like, my brain can't handle all this. It's a hum, and it's constant.
Yeah. And that's what popcorn brain was, if people didn't hear it, is it is something that is an effect of people trying to multitask. And they found that we try to do multiple tasks thinking that we're being more effective and we're saving time, but they've proven that if you focus on one task at a time, the brain works better in a linear motion. So you're not doing anything better by doing two things at once. You need to handle little challenges one at a time. And they said, too, that the brain likes to handle smaller tasks that it can get done. Those larger projects, it's going to take a bit of time. A lot of times we just subconsciously filter those out and keep pushing those back. And you want to have that satisfaction. It's almost like getting a click or a like on social media. Your brain likes to be able to check off an accomplishment. So if you can, maybe rifle through the small little things first. You do need to prioritize your tasks, but yeah, you cannot do multiple things at one time effectively. So if you think you can, you're kidding yourself. And if you're doing it, try to stop.
Do you think the menopause is triggering some stuff?
Definitely. Definitely. The brain is changing. Definitely. The thinking is changing. And I just feel like I have a different vibration.
Yeah, it could be. I think chemically, at different stages in our life, there are hormones and other processes, and that does ultimately affect our thinking.
I just feel like I can't be, like, peaceful. And even, like, last night I was talking to my husband, and we were talking about something. And he looked at me, he's like, are you okay? And I'm like, no, I'm not, because I can't focus on our conversation. Uh-huh. I'm thinking about five other things that I either have to do or set up or that's coming up I got to take care of. Like, I can't even focus on a conversation because of this low vibration hum in my brain and body.
Do you write down your tasks that you have to do?
Every day.
Do you do time blocking where you set aside certain times for those projects so you know in this space I'm here to do this?
Kind of, but sometimes that stuff's out of my control too. So, like, I'll have a list of stuff that I have to do, and then I kind of have to be flexible based on the children, the husband, the this, the that, the client that I'm going to see today at 1 p.m. Like, it has to be able to be adjustable.
First of all, let me ask you a couple things. A, do you want a hug from me or Kevin or Denny's or Suits? B, are you seeing anybody professionally? Because maybe we should start talking about that. And then C, do you really need a hug? I'll get you breakfast, whatever you need. Let's make this Friday fun and peaceful for you.
I just want to stop vibrating. I don't like it.
I think you're putting too much pressure on yourself, one. I think a lot of us do that. And sometimes you need to stand up to people in your life. You need to say no more frequently and tell them, that's not realistic. I can't do that. I think we try to take on too much. I'm very guilty of that.
Wait, Virginia needs to stand up to people more? I don't know.
I need to say no.
Yes.
I need to look at the calendar and say, uh-uh.
Yeah.
I know there's a space there for that,
right,
but I'm going to save that space for me.
What it doesn't sound like you're doing is you need to almost schedule junk time. And that time is where you get little small projects done or you allow flexibility in your schedule. So if your kids throw it off, you're not freaking out because you've budgeted for a cushion in time.
No, you're right.
And I think that might help you out.
It's an issue, and it's something that I do have to get, because every minute is planned.
Like, I think every person has to do it. Yeah, and I'm the same way. I look at my schedule, and I'm like, okay, yeah, we'll do it. In fact, your husband was like, hey, let's take off and go to the ball game today. I've had two invites now to go to the ball game, and I was getting ready to get back to him. I'm like, I really want to go to the baseball game today, and then I started looking at what I got to do. I'm like, that's not realistic, Kev. as much as you want to go, you just can't do it. So unfortunately, I can't go to the ball game with your husband today.
Damn.
And I really wanted to. But, you know, that's just the way it goes. That's life. Got to prioritize. Got to budget.
This is a fun Friday picking up.
I know, right?
You're right, though. I do have to schedule gaps.
Yeah.
And if I don't schedule the gaps, then the whole thing will just be filled up with task. Ugh.
But I agree with y'all. Y'all need some junk time.
We do.
Come on over to Sasquatch North. We'd love to have you at my house.
Did you say junk or drunk?
Both. Whatever you want. All the sweets in the world. Whatever you need, Mama. Let's get you happy today.
What's on your mind, Kevin?
You know, I'm going to switch it up because it was a little bit darker. And so I'm going to switch it up for everybody right now. I'm going to do something a little bit lighter for y'all.
Cool. Thank you.
Yeah. Virginia may not like this, but Bird will. Space news.
Ooh.
Oh, yes. Space.
And I want to talk about Uranus, which I know Virginia likes to talk about. They found it's got another moon.
Really?
Yeah. If you're keeping track, it now has 28.
I mean, after 10, you go, all right. It's got a lot of moons.
I mean, come on. How many moons does one planet need? We got one.
He's a little moon greedy. Yeah.
But you know NASA was so excited. We got another moon,
guys.
We
got another moon, 28. Yeah, they were doing those nerdy high fives.
Yeah, man. Chest bump. Yeah, here we go.
NASA high fives are some of my favorite things on the planet.
Neptune is trying to keep up. They've discovered two more moons with Neptune. They're now at 16. And here we are. I got moon envy. I don't know about you guys, but we got one.
But here's the weird thing. If all of a sudden a second moon just popped up into the sky and scientists just said, yep, yeah, Earth has a second moon and it's been hidden the whole time. And
that'd be huge.
But it would be huge for a month and then people would go, oh my gosh, this isn't a TikTok video with the Kardashians. I don't think people would care that much. If everything stayed the same.
I feel like people would care a lot more than you're giving them credit for a second moon.
I want to be wrong. I hope I'm wrong.
Okay.
I hope I'm wrong.
I would think that'd be.
You are wrong a lot.
I think that'd be a pretty big deal. I think it might hold on for a while.
I think it would hold
on. I know our news cycles move fast, but.
I think it'd hold on for about 2 months. And if nothing changed and everything stayed the same, people would go back to their regular life.
I think there would be a bunch of memes going on. People would do that thing. There was a famous scene from Star Wars. You probably know it, Jay Bird. Luke Skywalker, you got the two suns that are setting in the background. I think people would be doing the same thing with the moon. They'd be trying to dress like Luke Skywalker. Oh, that would be a social media thing. They'd be going crazy.
It would turn goofy and fun. But no one...
Denny's would change their menu to two moons over Miami.
Denny's needs to change their entire restaurant.
Yeah, well, that would give, you know, gives them something to work on. So, yeah, I mean, if we added at least one more moon to try to keep up with these other planets, that would be huge. Another fun little thing that I saw here today, researchers may have found the genetic quirk that made our early ancestors stop growing tails.
Oh, man.
He's been saying for a hot minute he wants to grow a tail.
So imagine if they found what stopped it, if they could flip the switch and make it start. Would you want a tail, Bird?
Yes.
Okay.
100%. 1,000%.
This could be the next cosmetic procedure that we could do. Imagine if you went out there with your new tail in the second moon and did a video.
Oh, my gosh. It's all happening at that point.
Shake Your Tail Feather would be your song.
How great would that be?
Think about how much society would change.
Can you imagine what happened to the fashion industry?
People
would be blinging their tail. They'd be having tail exits. All these kind of things you'd be doing with your tail. Cars would change.
I'll tell you who would do very well with a tail. Kanye.
Yes.
He would.
Absolutely. He may have one already. I'm not sure. We need to check. Yeah, they think this happened about 25 million years ago that we stopped with the tails.
How long were they? I wonder.
Great question. That I don't know. Doesn't say in the story. But there you go. That's some nonsensical stuff. I thought I'd break up this Friday for you. You need a little bit of fun. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, what is going on this weekend? We're going to let you know that. And did Jay Bird's dad catch a shark?
Whoa.
It's kind of debatable because he thinks he did, but not everybody agrees with him. So we'll let you know what's going on with that coming up.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
I'm what you might call very good at hide and seek. This one time, my parents had to round up the whole neighborhood to track me down. It was a mess. A lot of tears. Well, now that we got Xfinity, we have Wi-Fi all over the house, including all my favorite super secret hiding spots. So I can kill time in here by streaming my shows and...
Ha! Found ya.
The heck? How?
You left to find my tablet on.
This generation, ruining the game with their performance enhancers.
Get wall-to-wall Wi-Fi from Xfinity for a reliable connection throughout your home. Now through March 5th, get gig speed internet for $35 a month for 12 months when you add unlimited mobile. Plus, get Wi-Fi equipment included for 2 years. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra and may change. Gig speed Wi-Fi requires gig internet and Xfinity gateway. After 12 months, internet increases to $60. After 24 months, regular rates apply. Xfinity Mobile requires Xfinity internet. Actual speeds vary.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
What does it take to get the job done right? If you're one of the people at Art Plumbing, AC, and Electric, it means skill, dedication, and not only knowing what the plumbing, AC, or electrical problem is, but also being able to show the customer just what's needed to fix it. And above all, it means being there when you call. Art is there with what you need. Art can fix it.
Save money on groceries with Winn-Dixie Rewards. It's easy. Let's break it down. Unlock weekly sale prices on winning deals. Earn 2% to 15% back every single shop. Save big with digital coupons picked for you. Plus, new members score $5 off. Sign up today. Download the app or visit winn-dixie.com. Save more with Winn-Dixie Rewards. Winn-Dixie. It's a win-win. Terms and exclusions apply. See store or visit winn-dixie.com/rewards-terms for more details. $5 off a $30 purchase. 2% to 15% back. Eligible on qualifying purchases.
Navage provides quick, drug-free nasal relief this time of year when everyone is sick. Navage helps by sucking out germs, bacteria, and viruses trapped in our noses that cause us to feel miserable. And come allergy season, it does the same with dust, pollen, and other allergens. And unlike medications that can take time to help, Navage helps treat congestion symptoms in seconds flat. Ask for Navage at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Target, or find us online at Navage.com. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E. Clean nose, healthy life.
Did you know that you can travel in the I-95 express lanes for free? With this program from the Florida Department of Transportation, you can. Carpool with two or more other people and ride the I-95 express lanes for free. Your smarter commute starts at CarpoolMiami.com.
Want your child to go to summer camp, but afraid you can't afford it? Did you know you can apply for one of the more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships available right now for Palm Beach County children? Now is the time to apply for camp scholarships. The deadline is April 12th. To learn more, go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Dollars, cash, greenbacks. However you save money, you're going to save thousands during the President's Day sales event going on right now at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Nick Rivers, right now, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Bring in any trade and get up to a $5,000 discount off any select new Kia in stock. Take home a sporty new 2024 Kia Forte for only $219 a month, 24-month lease with $2,799 due at signing. Or get 0.9% APR financing on the new 23 Kia Sorentos. You worried about your credit? Get pre-qualified online without affecting your credit score at GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. Save thousands during the President's Day sales event at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS. Follow them on Facebook. Online anytime. GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. And remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Qualified applicants through KMF. 10,000 miles per year. Security deposit waived. Zero down. $24.96 per 1,000 financed for 48 months at 0.9% APR financing. Plus tax tag and $9.99 admin fee. Negative equity refinanced. Offers don't combine. Expires March 5th.
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider Smith, Ivy, and Fromrath at FourYearRights.com.
Be a part of the show. Mail at kvjshow.com or send us a message on the 97.9 WRMF app. Or just pick up the phone and call us. 877-979-WRMF. Now back to the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Looks like we're going to have another great weekend here in South Florida. And there's so much stuff going on here, from the Cognizant Classic Golf Tournament at PGA National that you can go check out this weekend. Everybody going to be getting crazy up in the bear trap tomorrow. Probably a little bit on Sunday as well. You've also got spring training baseball that is going to be going on at all three of our parks all weekend long.
I know we're throwing out the first pitch at one of the games, but you should try to get a day of baseball on your own.
I'm going to, yeah.
Good.
I'm trying. Yeah, we'll see. Hopefully I can work something into the schedule here one of these days. Because, I think by the 28th, that's when the regular season starts. So everybody going to be gone by the end of this month.
My dad wanted to go. Maybe you and him should go.
Okay. That'd be lovely. Yeah.
Oh, I'll go with your dad.
I'll drive you. I'll be your guy's Uber. Not you, Virginia.
Just drop us off.
I'll probably end up going, too.
Okay. Yeah, that'd be nice. We'd like to have you. That'd be a lot of fun. So all those things are going on this weekend outdoors. Going to be a lot of fun. And then also we've got the Rib Roundup that is going to be happening at the I Think Financial Amphitheater. Lainey Wilson, Nate Smith, Warren Zeiders, Rodney Atkins, all going to be on the three stages they have. Over 10 rib vendors are going to have out there as well.
Rubbers. When you say rib vendors, are we talking restaurants, or can a person just make great ribs and be in their own house?
Yeah,
and
if
bring
I remember,
them?
I think it might have been last year. One of the winners, or one of the top three, was, I think it was just two dudes that they took great pride in their barbecue and they somehow got into the competition.
Good for them.
Some ribs are better at the house, man. There's people who really take pride in their ribs.
No, there really are. There are people. It's kind of, you know, everybody's got their own thing. What
yes.
it might be, your own little clique. And I know Dave Grohl, the lead singer of the Foo Fighters, he's really big into grilling meat, and it goes into a whole thing about what kind of grills you get, rubs, seasonings, your techniques, your utensils, and, you know, like any other craft or hobby that people have, they go all in.
Oh, and within that community, there are people who fight. Oh, you're not supposed to do that kind of rub,
right,
with the rib.
Yeah.
Like anything, people are fighting.
Yeah, they love it. Yeah, absolutely. So got all those things going on. We've also got a soccer game on Sunday night. Inter Miami is going to be taking on Orlando City. I believe that's kind of like their rival. That's going to be the newly named Chase Stadium there in Fort Lauderdale. So you're going to have Lionel Messi back on the pitch. So we'll see what kind of celebrities we get out there. Last time you had Will Smith at their last game.
Is that a term we should know, back on the pitch? Is that a soccer term?
If you
term?
Want to start getting into, football.
Was that mean?
The pitch is the field that
okay.
they play on. You know, basketball has a court.
Yeah.
Football has a field. Football or soccer has a pitch.
Did you know this, Virginia?
I did not.
Learning.
I thought pitching was baseball.
I did too.
I know,
so
right?
confused.
Yeah, there's a lot of confusion.
And don't quiz us later.
And when I look out there, it looks like a field to me. I'm so confused.
Yeah. You've also got some big artists going to be rolling through South Florida. The Eagles are going to be here tonight and tomorrow at Hard Rock Live.
Missing a lot of notable people.
They are. It's really maybe arguably three guys from the original Eagles, and they used to have, what, five or six?
They started off with five.
They've got Glenn Frey's son in it, and then Vince Gill, who you know is a country artist, is in the Eagles now.
Yes, and I don't think he necessarily loves the gig because, of course, Eagles fans, that's not Glenn Frey. We want Glenn. Well, Glenn's passed away.
Yeah, so his son takes that role.
Small Frey.
Yeah,
it is Small Frey, yeah.
Small Fry, I like that.
That's good. That's exactly what it is. Then you got Bob Dylan. He's going to be at the Broward Center tonight and tomorrow.
Oh, cool. The crappy Tom Petty.
Aww.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kind of kidding.
Yeah, we are.
Just
kind
of kidding.
Yeah, didn't you go to his show and you were like, man, sing the old stuff?
No, that was Neil Young.
Oh, Neil Young.
He sang every song off his new album and every song was political.
Oh, no.
The Cirque du Soleil Echo is going on at Gulfstream Park in Hallandale Beach again this weekend. It's the final weekend for the St. Lucie County Fair on Midway Road in Fort Pierce. They're also doing the Festival of the Arts Boca at Meisner Park Amphitheater starting this weekend, showing a lot of movies and things like that. If you like the arts, go and check that out. They're doing Old Town Untapped in downtown Pompano Beach. And if you want to go dance with the hippies on the beach, they're doing that tonight in Lake Worth, a little bonfire.
I gotta get out there one of these days or one of these nights.
I don't believe it's a weed free event.
You don't believe it's a weed free event?
I don't believe. Yeah, just to let you know. A fun event that I love, the Maple Bacon Coffee Porter Festival. They do that at Funky Buddha Brewery in Oakland
yes.
Park. It's a limited release. They only do it pretty much this one time a year, but they close down the parking lot and people are just kind of walking around drinking craft beer and all that stuff.
Fun?
So it is. Yeah, it's a well attended. Cool event. They're doing the Los Olas Art Fair in Fort Lauderdale Saturday and Sunday. And you've also got some other cool stuff going on this weekend, like the Sunday Jazz Brunch on Riverwalk in Fort Lauderdale. So going to be a good weekend there for you to check out.
Did you get that event that I sent you for tomorrow for Little Smiles? You know who this baseball player is? You know baseball.
Mm-hmm.
Rico Petrocelli. I guess he played for the Red Sox. He's on the Red Sox Hall of Fame. He's going to be out with Little Smiles at County Line Restaurant tomorrow, signing autographs and raising money. And so I'm going to stop out there and meet Rico Petrocelli.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
That is cool. Very nice. What year did he play?
No big deal. I'll be running with some baseball people. No big deal.
He's old school.
Yeah, he's old school and signing autographs and memorabilia and then like giving everything to Little Smiles.
Look at that. He's a two-time All-Star shortstop, Kev.
Huh.
Played in two World Series with the Red Sox, 67 and 75. Some good stats there.
Yeah, I'll be hanging with them tomorrow. No big deal.
Very cool. They're also doing the Midnight Sun Festival, celebrating Finnish culture and Lake Worth heritage. That's going to be this weekend at Bryant Park in Lake Worth Beach.
Nice.
Yeah, Finnish. I bet you don't know a lot about Finland, do you?
I don't. I had a friend from Finland, though, and every time the waitress would come up and say, are you finished with your plate? He would go, yes, I am finished.
Yes, I am finished.
That's awesome.
Gosh, I wish I was finished just so I could use that joke.
Get them every time.
Yeah.
Everybody at the table cackled.
Is it nice there? Is it a beautiful country?
I've never been. I'd love to see it, though.
Me too.
It sounds like it'd be lovely. So, I don't know. Go to Lake Worth Beach and ask them.
Woo-hoo.
Is it lovely there? Oh, coming up here in a couple of minutes, Jay Bird's dad believes he caught a shark, but apparently there's a debate about that. We'll hear what it is coming up next.
Yeah, I'm out at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. But I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem. All of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's. Took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry. Cruising down A Street, off-white Lexus. Driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm out that Bed-Stuy, home of that boy Biggie. Now I live on Billboard, and I brought my boys with me. Say what up to Tata, still sipping my top. Sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I most definitely from I made the Yankee hat more famous than a Yankee can. You should know I bleed blue, but I ain't a crypto. But I got a gang of walking with my click though. Welcome to the melting pot. Corners where we selling. Africa been by the home of the hip hop. Yellow cap, gypsy cap, dollar cap, holla back. For foreigners, it ain't fair. They act like they forgot how to act. 8 million stories out there in the naked. City is a pity, half of y'all won't make it. Me, I got a plug special, and I got it made. If Jesus paying LeBron, I'm paying Dwayne Wade. 3 dice CeeLo, 3 card Marley. Labor Day parade, rest in peace, Bob Marley. Statue of Liberty, long live the World Trade, long live the King, yo. I'm from the Empire State. That's blinding. Girls need blinders so they could step out of bounds quick. The sidelines is lined with casualties who sip the life casually then gradually become worse. Don't fight the apple Eve. Caught up in the in crowd. Now you're in style and in the winter gets cold. In vogue with your skin out. City of sin is a pity on a whim. Good girls going bad. The city's filled with them. Mommy took a bus trip. Now she got a bust out. Everybody ride her just like a bus route. Hail Mary to the city. You're a virgin and Jesus came
can't save you. Life starts when the church in. Came here for school, graduated to the highlight. Ball players, rap stars, addicted to the limelight. Empty in May, got you feeling like a champion. The city never sleeps, better slip you an ambient.
In South Florida visiting from Texas, and he believes he caught a shark, but did he? That is the big question. So Jaybird, where exactly did your dad believe he caught this shark, and how big was it?
That North Palm Beach intercoastal area, my family calls it Daisy Park. I think it's called
Anchorage.
Not Anchorage, but it's
Anchor Park.
No, it's not. I know where Anchorage is at.
So it's more on the intercoastal than in.
Yeah, I think it's called Lakeside Park. It's in North Palm Beach. But okay. Yeah. So my dad was out there fishing, and he caught what he believes is a shark. My sister believes it's a shark. They're all excited. They take a picture of it. Uh-huh. The guy fishing next to him butts in, interrupts them, doesn't even know them. That's not a shark. Nope. Sand perch. Not a shark.
Sand perch?
He said it was a sand perch or some kind of a... So we've got pictures here, and I thought the good people could let us know.
Okay.
Perch.
Okay.
The guy that was next to my dad, who my dad did not know, was claiming that it was not a shark. It was some type of...
Oh, you're right. It is called Lakeside Park.
Lakeside Park. Yeah, that's what it's at. Okay. It's a beautiful park, by the way.
It is. It's right there on the water. I love that park.
If you have children, I highly recommend going there. There's places to play.
There's a swing set, big swings that look out over the intercoastal. It's beautiful.
It's free.
Okay.
Just don't go there past 7 p.m. The cops will shut that down.
So you don't know if it's a sand perch or a real shark.
Well, I said suits the picture. It should be on KVJ TV. I'm showing you, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
That looks like a land shark to me, or a sand shark.
A land shark.
What? Sand shark.
I'll have a land shark and a shot of tequila. That does not look like a shark.
No.
It's a baby. I'm telling you. It's a baby sand shark. We looked up the pictures.
Really? A sand shark. Okay. Now, he said it was sand perch, and you're saying it's sand shark?
My dad definitely said it was a shark of sorts. What's the people saying? Because you guys don't know anything about fish. You guys are about to eat it.
Yeah, I don't.
I don't know a sand shark.
I'm looking at a photo of a sand shark, and it looks like it got a lot of fins. In fact, it looks like it's got your typical dorsal fin that's got two others on its back. So it's a kind of an interesting-looking shark.
Hmm.
Then if it's not a shark, what the heck is it? My dad de-hooked it.
There's going to be some fisherman guy that knows exactly what that is.
I know. I can't read the comments because everyone thinks they know. Like, it's not a sand shark, bird. And then it is a sand shark.
Have you posted on our social media yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
I was gonna have you guys make fun of it first.
It's a Malaysian tiger fish, you dumbass.
That's exactly
that's what somebody's going to say.
Because fishermen get big.
They're going to yell at you and make you feel stupid.
Fishermen are a lot like golfers. If you're not in that world, they like to make you feel real stupid about the things you don't know.
Yeah.
I remember I posted something about a shark in the water. I'm like, oh, there was sharks over here. Oh, no crap, you dumbass. You live in Florida. I'm like, okay, well.
And that's not a shark. You're stupid.
Yeah.
Now, one text says that a sand perch is only about an inch long.
It's definitely not a sand perch.
It's that, longer than an inch.
That I know for a fact. I know what a sand perch looks like.
To me, it looks like some species of fish over shark.
Well, if you ask my dad, he is certain it's a shark.
Okay. Well, he knows more about that stuff than I do. Well, we'll see what the people say.
Yeah, we got to put on social media.
Yeah, a sand perch is tiny.
It's definitely not a sand
perch. It's not a sand perch.
We can eliminate that one. But yeah, is it a shark or not? So we'll post that up on Instagram and Facebook, and then we'll see what the people have to say with the photo your dad took.
But even that right there shows you that fisherman claimed he knew exactly what it was, and it's definitely not a sand. Oh, it's a sand perch.
I think fishermen do that a lot.
Let's go back there today and see if he's there so we can tell him how wrong he is.
I got a feeling that guy's there every day.
Yasik said, my husband said it looks like a flying fish.
Flying fish?
Wilfredo said it's a lizard fish.
Lizard fish?
Okay, so there's a lot of comments leading in the fish direction. We'll post it up and see what people say.
Are we saying my dad did not catch a shark? I don't want to have to tell
right
him.
Now, we'll see what the... We'll see what the consensus is after we post it up on social media, but right now it's not looking like it is.
I'm going to post it, but Kevin, you got to read the comments because I will get into a social media fight today.
Okay. All right. Well.
You should. Just fight with everybody about what kind of fish it is.
I should just go in there. It's a sheephead shark. Just make up my own.
It's a Malaysian sheephead pinfish.
It's a gigging shark.
Just start making stuff up.
Coming up here in a couple of minutes, Tom Brady has done something that, again, people question his humanity. Is he really a man? Could he be a machine? What exactly is he doing? He has defied aging once again. We'll tell you how coming up next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike, but we do have a crash to watch for that is tying you up on Malaluka Lane. This is at Military Trail. And another wreck is tying you up on Lake Victoria Drive, right at the intersection of Golden River Drive. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Hey, West Palm Beach, looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Last year, over 3 million people called Morgan & Morgan in their time of need. And with over 1 million of those calls coming from previous clients, friends, and family.
My name is Jason Williams. It was a rainy day, and I got hit from behind by a lady that was doing somewhere over 100 miles an hour is what they were saying. I've never dealt with anything like this before. Everybody that I talked to kept saying the same name, which was Morgan & Morgan. I was on hold for maybe 15 seconds. When they come back and said, Jason, we will absolutely take your case. As a non-tech-savvy guy, any question that I had, if I called, text, or emailed, they got right back to me. They made it as easy for me as it could have been.
Thank you for trusting us. We've become the largest injury firm in the world because we've won a lot. The word is out. Size matters. Reputation matters. We're America's largest injury law firm for a reason. With over 900 dedicated attorneys and climbing, we're ready wherever you are, whatever you need. The choice is easy. We're just a phone call away. Injured? Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport.
now flying direct to Chicago. Visit pbia.org for more info.
Choose coverage that helps you keep more money in your pocket. If you're turning 65, new to Medicare, or have recently moved, you could get $1,978.80 back each year with the Humana Medicare Advantage Humana Choice PPO plan. You'll also get a $0 monthly plan premium, prescription drug coverage, and now, every single Humana Medicare Advantage plan also includes routine dental, vision, and hearing coverage. With benefits, support, and money back in your Social Security check, Humana Medicare Advantage plans help take care of your health and your wallet. Learn more at gethumana.com. Humana, a more human way to healthcare. The Part B Give Back benefit pays part or all of your Part B premium, and the amount may change based on the amount you pay for Part B. Limitations and restrictions may apply. Humana is a Medicare Advantage PPO organization with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in any Humana plan depends on contract renewal.
Dunkin's, iced coffee with a French vanilla swirl, vanilla shot, sweet cold foam, and cinnamon sugar topping. America runs on Dunkin'. Price and participation may vary. Limited time offer.
Victim of a slip and fall? It takes one phone call to take back control of your life. Anajar and Levine will fight to get you the compensation you deserve. Call me, Mark Anajar, for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Mostly cloudy with areas of patchy fog, especially those inland spots. Otherwise, it is muggy. The few passing showers too possible this morning. Temperatures in the upper 60s throughout the morning. Heating up fast, though, into the low 80s this afternoon with partly to mostly cloudy skies. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by HCA Florida Healthcare.
Whenever you need us, just reach out and we'll be there. With more locations, more experts, and more resources to deliver the healthcare you need to comfort you and make you feel your best. Find a care site near you at hcafloridahealthcare.com.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Are you using the 97.9 WRMF app? If not, you should be. Oh man, there is so much stuff going on there. You talk about hot concerts. We got Taylor Swift, Justin Timberlake, Olivia Rodrigo, all those tickets right now on the 97.9 WRMF app. Beautiful thing about it, you download it for free. You can listen to us live, and the more you listen, the better your chance of scoring those tickets. But we also have cash and trips to give away as well, and the KBJ regular show is on there, plus our bonus after the show. And it's all just one simple free download you can do right now. Okay, the photo is posted on social media, our KBJ Instagram, and also our KBJ Facebook page. It is Jay Bird, Dad, and he's out there. Boy, he's got his pole in his hand. He looks so proud of himself right there in North Palm Beach. And here is the fish, maybe shark, that he thinks he wrangled in. And people are leaving their comments right now. Candace said, LOL, not a shark. Okay, that's just one comment.
I think we've solved the mystery, Kev. It's a lizard fish.
Oh, it's a lizard fish.
Well, okay. Everyone kept on saying it's a lizard fish, and then I looked up lizard fish. We didn't know what to look up.
Uh-huh, okay.
So it's kind of hard to look it up, and I did, and it's kind of a spitting image of what my dad caught. Okay. Right. The lizard fish is.
Okay, so now we know.
I think we do know. Hmm.
The lizard fish, by the way, horrifying.
It's not. I kind of can see why my dad thought it might be a shark because of them teeth.
It's definitely scary and intimidating.
Yeah, it's a scary looking fish. I'll give him that.
He hooked that thing.
Yeah, he did. It's an impressive catch. You let him know that.
I don't know if it is. People are calling it like a bottom dweller of the sea.
Yeah, it's not good to eat according to the website.
It's terrible to eat.
All around, it's a terrible catch.
My whole family have been the worst fishermen.
And what sucks, not a lot of big conquest or stories.
Well, my dad loves it.
Yeah.
And,
Does your dad want to go like in a boat and go fishing?
No, because I think he gets boat sick.
He's got to be one of them landlocked fishermen.
He gets seasick.
Yeah.
Aww.
Okay. Well, mystery solved though.
Yeah.
Right. Well, you can see the fun photo. It's still posted up on our social media. I don't even have a little bit of fun. Your dad is over at your place, and Jaybird, I could tell, got himself a new little prank that he was trying on everybody yesterday. Virginia, I know he tried it on you.
Yeah.
It's okay.
He tried it on me while I was trying to work. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I can see him out of my peripheral vision.
Peripheral?
I don't know how to say it. Peripheral? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I'm trying to work, and I'm like, why is he watching me? He never watches me work.
Okay, so he threw it off. He did something unusual.
I was editing something, and I'm like, he's eyeballing me. I'm like, what is he up to? Sure enough, he was trying to get me.
It's a dumb, it's stupid. I get it's not a very good prank, but I still had fun doing it.
Yeah.
So
I went home and got Rocco with it. He cackled. Rocco loved your prank.
It's blowing up on YouTube. It's got almost 9,000 views on YouTube.
Wow. Rocco loved it.
For none of y'all bit but my dad.
He went in, huh? Kind of like that fish he caught. You got him hook, line, and sinker?
You
got
to really watch the video because he's very confused.
Okay. It's the Cal Say prank, and here's how it goes. This is Jaybird with his dad.
You see my Cal Say? I left it here the last time I was here.
What?
It's like this big. The Cal Say.
It's for like the music or something? Like your guitar?
No, it's for work. A Cal Say.
What's a Cal Say?
Moo! Moo! Moo!
He's confused.
A Cal Say. What does a Cal Say? Moo. Get it?
Yeah, I kind of get it, yeah.
Got Jaybird.
He loves it.
You got to watch his reaction.
He loves it.
He's like, wait, what?
Okay, you just know what's
what just happened to me?
I get it. Nobody knew what was going on.
Well, Tom Brady is just defying aging and science and everything involved with it. He did this video where he was at the NFL Combine, which is going on this weekend. This is where college football players go and they see how strong and how fast they are. Well, they kind of joke and they always troll Tom Brady because he took this shirtless photo back when he's in his early 20s getting into the NFL and he didn't look that physically fit. So he goes back at the age of 46 to see how he would do in the 40-yard dash, which is what they run to see how fast you are at the NFL Combine.
24 years ago, I ran a 5.28 40-yard dash. If we have some extra time, maybe we give the 40 one more shot. Let's see if we can level up. Let's go.
Come on, come on, go.
5.18, 5.12
on the second.
If you did that 25 years ago, you could
draft. That was fun. Next year, it's going to be faster.
Yeah, if you'd have done that, because he's drafted in the sixth round. He would have been drafted in the third round if you'd have ran that 25 years ago.
And just like that, Brady's coming out of retirement.
You know there'll be that talk.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So he went from running a 5.28 to a 5.12.
Modern medicine really is amazing when it comes to cells rejuvenating themselves through technology.
I have a feeling this is an advertisement for the TB12 company that he has that is all about rejuvenation and wellness and fitness.
Which is worth millions.
All those old school wrestlers that start to get into their 50s and 60s, they say all that rejuvenating their muscles and their body, they go, oh yeah, it works. It works very well.
Yeah,
and
it does.
You feel... Yeah. It gives you back like 20 years.
It does.
I went and tried it. Remember, I had that endorsement for QC Kinetics.
Mm-hmm.
And I would go there and they would, seriously, wherever you had an issue, they would shoot you up with stem cell rejuvenating stuff. And then all of a sudden you don't have pain in that area anymore. And you're like, what kind of voodoo do you do?
Kevin Nash, he's a former wrestler, and he got in his 50s. He said, "It goes, I feel like I was in my 30s again.
It's real. It really is real. If you have injury from sports or life or anything, you can be like Tom Brady. You can heal yourself and be faster than you were in your 20s.
If everybody on the KBJ show ran a 40-yard dash, who finishes first, who finishes last?
I can tell you last.
I don't want to do this, Kevin. I feel like it's mean.
Okay.
It is mean, but...
We'll let people sound off. We'll let the people be mean. What do you think? You can comment right now if you're watching us on YouTube. Just look for the KVJ show. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, it's amazing what machines are doing today. And I'm not just talking about Tom Brady. I'm talking about what they're doing for us. There was a cartoon way back in the day called The Jetsons, and they had robots doing all these things. There is now a new thing that, ladies, if you love beauty and wellness, it is a new machine for you. And it's not even just the one that puts on your eyelashes. I told you about that a week or so ago.
Yes.
It's something else. It's doing it just as well as humans, and it's saving you a ton of money. I'll tell you what it is next.
I only talk to God when I need a favor. And I only pray when I ain't got a prayer. So who the hell am I? Who the hell am I to expect a savior? Oh, if I only talk to God when I need a favor. God, I need a favor. I know amazing grace, but I ain't been living them words. Swear I spend more Sundays drunk off my ass than I have in church. Hardcover King James, only been saving dust on the nightstand. And I don't know what to say. Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me. Oh, my God, Hail Mary. Hanging in there, just barely throwing up prayers. Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me.
Just last week, I was telling you about the robot that they now have that is putting on those fake eyelashes that the ladies love. My wife, oh my gosh, she goes like every other week to get her lashes done. It's a huge thing for her.
I was doing that for a while, but it's too time consuming.
And I thought so too.
I can't lay there for an hour and 30 minutes. I can't.
It takes my wife an hour, and she usually just takes a nap. So she's out cold and does it. But yeah, it is very time consuming.
I'm too paranoid to sleep in a room with strangers.
Yeah. You're paranoid?
So they got this robot that'll do it for you, but it looks kind of sinister. It's this weird arm that comes over and does your eyelashes for you, and I don't know if I'm completely there yet.
One wrong robot move, and you're blind.
Well, I know, but you look at humans, too. What do you trust more, I guess? That's the question.
True.
They have this machine that not only does the eyelashes, but now they also have a robot that is doing manicures, and they say that it is saving the ladies a ton of money. One woman only spent $8 at one of these robot manicurists at a Target.
So I got my nails painted at school for $10 by a robot. It was inside my bookstore, which was a little awkward. They give you like a thing to clean your nails, which is really cool. I took that home. And then so you have to, it says literally in the intro video, do not take a video because it takes a picture of your finger. And if you move in the slightest, you get paint all over your fingers. But it did a really good job and it was only $10. And like, you know, you don't have to include tip in or anything. So it was like perfect. These are like the end product.
Yeah.
You don't have to do tip now, but wait till robot rights start to be a thing. You'll start tipping your robot and it'll become a thing.
I bought something online again yesterday and it asked me if I wanted to tip the team. I'm like, what?
Well, that's why you're seeing, honestly, the tipping thing is out of control. And people do like this. People still want all these things. They want their eyes and nails done and all that stuff. So if you can have a machine do it and you take away, I think the tipping culture is going to drive people to more robot stuff.
I'm telling you guys right now.
They would revolt. I just think people wouldn't do it. I'm like, I'm not tipping a robot. Get out of your mind.
It's going to be to where it won't be tipping. They'll use a different term, robot surcharge. They're going to get tips out of you. If they're making money on it, off of it, the tip's never going out. They'll charge you more.
I don't see that being a thing.
Well, people didn't think we'd be in the beginning stages of a robot warfare, and we are. We are now. We're entering it now.
Robot war?
Y'all think I'm crazy.
Well, we do think you're crazy, but I don't think you're necessarily wrong.
I'm not wrong.
You think we're going to be tipping robots?
I think robots are going to start assimilating more and more. And eventually, he's right. I think people are going to be so stupid. They're going to be like, yeah, the robots need rights too.
I'm telling you that's going to happen.
Starts in San Francisco.
It definitely starts on the West.
It starts on the West Coast.
Yeah. Yeah, they right now only have these robot manicurists in 6 Target stores, but they say that if they catch on, that they might start going other places.
What towns are they in? Are there any in South Florida?
No, nothing here right now. So they're trying it other places, and then hopefully it'll take off, and then we'll start getting them in South Florida.
If it was quick, I would do that.
I mean, yeah, getting your nails done for $8.
Getting your nails done, normally it takes like 40 minutes, right. And it costs like $40.
Right. Be a quarter of the money.
Yeah, I think in the beginning.
So we asked the question, if you could have an automated robot do one task for you, what would it be? What do you think the number one answer was, Virginia?
Child care.
It was not.
Damn it.
No.
That's what I struggled with.
Like, that one didn't even come up.
Oh, my gosh. I need help.
What do you think it is, Bird?
I don't want to sound dirty, but is it adult stuff?
No, it's not. Wow. That didn't
sexy
even come up either.
Time.
People are lying about on that
now,
list.
That robot you might have to tip. So I see where your mind was going. Yes, on that you may have to tip. No, it was cleaning your house.
Okay.
They want robots to clean house. That was number one. Laundry was number two. Cooking was 3, doing the dishes 4, and then hair and makeup was number 5 on there. If you could have a robot do a task for you, what you want it to be?
I swear, I'm not trying to be argumentative. They left off one that's going to be very popular, and it's what I talked about, the lovemaking stuff. That would be a huge industry.
It was on social media, so maybe nobody wanted to fly their freak flag on social media. Maybe be like, man, what are you doing?
But if we can speak honest.
Yeah. Nobody wanted to put their face to that comment, I think.
If we can speak like we're sitting at the bar.
If we had legit hard numbers on this thing, yeah.
Oh, hard numbers, huh?
Uh-huh. Okay, well, you want to jump into the conversation? You always can on our Instagram and Facebook pages.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, I was giggling when I saw this because I was kind of wondering when the change was going to happen. Oprah Winfrey is leaving the board of directors for Weight Watchers. Yeah, I think it's probably a good idea. We'll get into why coming up in your Dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anna Jar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anna Jar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-860-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike. You're up to speed for the most part. The only crash to watch for being reported on Lake Victoria Drive. Look for this one right at Golden River Drive. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
You know, this time of year can be, well, you know, a little taxing. But the good news is it's also the time of year when we can actually come into a little extra cash. And if you are, there's some cool things you could spend your money on. Maybe a little brunch, maybe a vacation, maybe a rental car to cruise down the coast. Well, this season, if you switch to Xfinity Internet and mobile, you can actually save and still have enough left over for all those big plans that you got to spend your money on. It's the next generation of Xfinity 10G network that you can check out right now. And now through March 4th, you can get 75 megabit internet on the Xfinity 10G network for $20 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. Just go to Xfinity.com/10G, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today to learn more. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas. Equipment taxes and fees extra. After promo, regular rates apply. Xfinity Mobile requires Xfinity Internet. Actual speeds may vary.
There is only one way to vote this year for the candidate that will make you laugh.
Okay, I'm in this strictly for the likes and the clicks.
That will make you sing. He's the voted orange lunatic. The Emmy and Grammy nominated comedian, Randy Rainbow, for president.
Okay, cut the
Friday, March 15th, Sunrise Theater. Tickets are on sale now at sunrisetheater.com. That's Sunrise, TheatreE.com. Randy Rainbow in an all-new musical comedy live performance.
We buy any car. We buy any car. We buy any car.
Did you know trading in your car at a dealer could cost you money? Research shows consumers who trade in their car pay an average of $990 more. So don't trade in, sell it to We Buy Any Car. Get your free online valuation now at
WeBuyAnyCar.com.
Research published in the Journal of Industrial Economics December 2015 showed buyers with a trade-in pay an average of $990 more than those who do not trade in their used cars.
As a radio stuntman, I do all the extreme stuff in your favorite commercials. But the new Times the Cash scratch-offs are a new level of action-packed. A thrilling multiplier feature, over 15 million prizes that multiply the winnings, and bonus play. They're the most extreme. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to jump this pit of hungry gates for no reason. New Times the Cash scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly!
Fargo, the new virtual assistant from Wells Fargo, makes banking faster and easier. Like this.
Fargo, what's my checking account routing number?
And this.
Fargo, turn off my debit card.
And this.
Fargo, what did I spend on groceries last month?
And that's just the beginning. Do you Fargo? You can. In the Wells Fargo mobile app. Learn more at wellsfargo.com/getfargo.
Terms and conditions apply. Your mobile carrier's availability and message and data rates may apply. Wells Fargo Bank, NA, member FDIC.
Hi, this is Amy, and I chose Brain Balance for my son Charlie because there were just some things that weren't right with him. He was a good kid, but he struggled with reading. He couldn't catch and throw a ball. He had anger issues. What drew me to Brain Balance was that they weren't going to medicate my child. Since we started Brain Balance, Charlie can now read chapter books. He plays football. He communicates with us. Someone asked me the other day if I had a magic potion for Charlie. My answer was yes, Brain Balance.
Call Brain Balance in Palm Beach Gardens or Coral Springs and schedule an assessment today. Did you know that you can travel in the I-95 express lanes for free? With this program from the Florida Department of Transportation, you can. Carpool with two or more other people and ride the I-95 express lanes for free. Your smarter commute starts at carpoolmiami.com.
Here at Massey, we've seen the damage termites can cause. That's why we've protected homes from termite damage for almost 100 years. Our termite protection program doesn't just protect your home from termites. It gives you peace of mind. That's why our termite protection guarantee covers your home and all the things in it. When we protect against termites, we protect families. Schedule your free inspection today at MasseyServices.com. Massey Services. Expect more and get it.
Has weight loss been a struggle for you in the past? Hey, it's Suits from the KVJ show, and I've tried a few of those weight loss programs, some where I didn't lose any weight, and some where I lost the weight, and then as soon as it ended, put it right back on. And if you've done this before and you've had the same results, you got to try Coastal Weight Loss Secret. Dr. Zuckerman and his team at Coastal Weight Loss Secret have a unique weight loss program that'll make it easy for you to lose that weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. I jumped on the program and was able to drop 30 pounds in just 2 months. And if you would like to lose the unhealthy fat like I did, you can do it without counting points or calories. There's no exercising, no surgeries, and none of those expensive prepackaged meals. Everything you need to be successful, you can pick up right at the grocery store. They'll teach you the secret to losing up to a pound of fat every day, and then they'll help you keep the weight off. That's what sets Coastal Weight Loss Secret apart from the others. I'm in the maintenance phase now. They stay with you to make sure you have the healthy habits to keep the weight off in the long term. Schedule a free consultation with Dr. Zuckerman. You can give them a call at 561-680-3090. That's 561-680-3090. Or visit them online at CoastalWeightLossSecret.com.
Experience the Anna Jar and Levine difference.
Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, Oprah Winfrey is leaving Weight Watchers, and you kind of knew this had to happen, right? Because if you, like me, have been watching everybody else who's also on Ozempic, you're like, yeah, Weight Watchers is not how Oprah's been keeping her weight under control. Oprah's like a size 4 or a size
She's the thinnest I've ever seen her.
She is definitely tiny right now, and that is not Weight Watchers, y'all. And she's even said it ain't Weight Watchers.
She did an interview, and as soon as I saw that, I'm like, there's no way she can keep with the Weight Watchers, because in a sense, she said the product that my face is on is not how I lost the weight, and it's not effective, so I had to go to something else.
Right, because here's the thing. When you do Weight Watchers, when you do any of these programs, when you're on the keto diet or the Frito diet or whatever it is, you have to have willpower. And the thing that these weight loss drugs give you is willpower. And it's unbelievable, and this is how they work. And even if you're going through menopause and you're having all the food cravings, the Ozempic takes away the food cravings. And there's just nothing like it on the planet. I've tried everything. Weight Watchers is hard to do.
My mom got kicked out of Weight Watchers. It was pretty amazing.
What happened?
There was something where the woman, I guess, are there counselors that you have to talk to or something?
Yes.
Well, the counselor was trying to scare my mom and Aunt Anne into not eating chocolate, and she was saying all these kind of things about rats jumping on chocolate, trying to scare them away from chocolate. And my mom was making jokes and said something about, well, as long as the rat doesn't leave a paw print, I'm still going to eat my chocolate. And the woman got mad, and she did like jokes, and didn't think my mom was taken seriously, so they got into a fight. My mom got kicked out.
Wow.
Yeah. We're talking 1980s Weight Watchers.
It kind of gives your mom street cred.
It does.
Impressive. Yeah, did you see the Weight Watchers stock crashed almost 25% after the announcement was made?
Yeah, I mean, look, Oprah's a kingmaker, but she can also take down the kingdom.
Oh, she has slayed that. She just killed Weight Watchers.
She just killed Weight Watchers, yeah.
It is what it is.
Honestly.
I think Ozempic killed Weight Watchers. And, I mean, Oprah just did the right thing by being honest. Because I think the worst thing, and we see this, too, is these celebrities that are out there saying, oh, no, I'm not on Ozempic. I've just been in the gym. Yeah, right, girl. You were a size 12. Now you're a size 2.
I do feel like if you just own what you're doing, if you're in the public eye, because people are going to always ask, why do you look that way? Why are you gaining weight? Why are you losing weight? What are you doing? And if you were just honest and say, yeah, I did this, it does seem to go away.
If you be honest, you never have to keep your story straight. And then you never have to, down the line, answer for your lies. Because now, I mean, Oprah's talking about how she was on it while she was the spokesperson for Weight Watchers.
Well, it's kind of like divorce. Like everyone's doing it. All these people are doing it.
You just got to be honest. And you just got to know that a lot of people are doing it. And if you lose, like, the weight of a small human, we know you're on it.
Yeah.
This is kind of fascinating. So in Jennifer Lopez's new documentary, The Greatest Love Story Never Told, I guess producers are on there, and it's like a behind-the-scenes shot of J-Lo's team working on the whole film. And I guess they reached out to a lot of celebrities and asked them if they want to do cameos in the J-Lo documentary. And a lot of people said they didn't want to do it. A lot of people turned them down, including Lizzo. So I guess this was like before the Lizzo scandal, and Lizzo maybe didn't know that her people turned it down, because now she's going public and saying, oh no, no one asked me. J-Lo, I love you. Nobody told me anything. Don't call me out for not wanting to be in your thing. But
she might have not wanted to do it before.
Exactly.
And now she ain't got no
gigs. Exactly.
So she, oh, I want to be a part of it.
Oh, I love you, J-Lo. Over here, Lizzo, remember me. And that's what's going on in your dirt.
I got a few celebrities having a birthday today. Big ol' happy birthday. Shout out to Justin Bieber. But for a birthday gift, don't send him a prayer. They don't want those now.
Do not ask for prayers for his marriage and his personal life.
No, no, they don't want those.
They don't want that.
Well, Stephen Baldwin.
Oh, yeah.
Haley's, her dad, went on social media and pretty much revealed to the world that they're having issues. And she's like, Dad, shh, please be quiet.
Stephen Baldwin's kind of a goof.
He is. He's a jabberjaw.
Biebs is 30 today. Kesha turns 37. Lupita Nyong'o is 41. She was in Black Panther and 12 Years a Slave. Won an award for that one. Mark Paul Gosselaar was Zach on Saved by the Bell. He turns 50 today. Ron Howard, former child actor and director, is turning 70. And Roger Daltrey, who once sang about how he hoped he died before he got old, his dream didn't come true. He hits 80 today.
Wow.
How about that? 80 years old. Also, happy birthday to Becky from your sister, Erin. Also, happy 7th birthday to Emma Jane in Loxahatchee from Mom, Dad, Trevor, and Mocha Browse. Love you very much. Also, got a happy birthday shout out to Kenzie turning 5. You're a cheeky devil. Sweet and spunky.
Look at that picture.
Mommy, Daddy, Sissy, Callie, Thomas, and Grandma. Check out that
cheeky
there on KBJ TV. Also, happy birthday to the best supermom, grilled cheese maker, pool table fondling, John Mayer loving, Jenga dominating, golden girl badass, Angie in Hollywood sent that, princess nurse, and Toffee, and there is their photo on KBJ TV.
So whose birthday is it out of that crew? Because we know that crew. Is it,
who, is it who's Toff? It for?
Nurse?
I don't know.
Well, happy birthday to all of you guys.
Happy birthday.
Doesn't say. It's just all those little things, and I guess it's an insider birthday that you would know who it is.
Well, good news is we know they all have birthdays, so happy birthday to you all.
Happy 41st birthday to the best husband and father of one human and so many furry children ever. And you can see the photo there. He was willing to risk back pain so our toddler could high-five a sign at the Lake Worth Street Painting Festival.
Aww.
That's awesome.
Oh, that's cute. That's what dads do. Happy 17th birthday to Leah from Mom, Dad, and Coco. There's a family photo on KBJ TV. Also, shout out to my grandson, Anthony Rosales, turning 11 tomorrow. Go Seminoles. Nana and Papa sent that in, and there he is at a Miami Heat game, the Kaseya Center.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah, always a good time. All right, if you got a birthday and you want to get a shout out, you can let us know about it. Mail at KBJShow, M-A-I-L at KBJShow.com. Have you seen the original Dune movie with Timothy Chalamet and Zendaya? I wonder if it's any good, because they're coming out with the sequel this weekend. The cast is amazing.
They're always promoting it, and I always want to watch it. And yeah. I just don't hit the button, Kev.
It must be good if they're doing a sequel. They've also added Austin Butler. He's going to be in the cast. So is Florence Pugh, Christopher Walken. Javier Bardem and Josh Brolin.
I know that that franchise or that story, it's got clout. People love it. They love Dune.
I heard today that it came out before the Star Wars story.
It is. It's got some old school ties
is
it, to
yeah,
it.
Is it Dune like old AF?
I believe it is,
yes,
yeah.
So.
Like from the 70s?
Yeah. So that is your big movie opening up in theaters this weekend. That Bob Marley story's been doing really well, too. So I wonder how it'll do head-to-head with that one. If you love your movies and you want to play this thing we have called the No Name Movie Game, where members of our show give you clues to movies, you should call us right now, 877-979-WRMF, 877-979-9763. Pair up. Let's play the No Name Movie Game next here on the KBJ Show.
An arrow to the heart. I never kissed a mouth that tastes like yours. Strawberries and something more. Ooh, yeah, I want it all. Lipstick.
To Stat Girl Whitney. She knows what's going on here. Suits is our current champion.
Okay. He did come in here kind of with his chest puffed out.
Well, I mean, got some clout going on.
He is in the lead, too, for the year with 4, followed by Virginia with 2. And me and the Bird have got 1 win on the year. Okay.
Wow, Suits, you're the guy to beat.
He's run away with it.
Feels good, Virginia.
In yet another game.
No, dude, everyone's talking about it.
Oh, yeah, no, it's the buzz around this place.
All right, well, let's see how it goes here. We got Suits coming up in a second and the Burr, but we're going to start off with Virginia and her partner, Jasper, from Palm Springs. Hello, Jasper.
Hi. Oh, my God, it's been so long. I was on the KBJ show when I was, like, 13.
Whoa!
Oh, welcome get back.
And now you're what, like 16, 17? What's that?
I said I met Virginia at Pride last year.
Oh,
very nice, yes.
We will be back at Pride this year. Look for us in the Pride Fest Parade on the 24th of March.
Yeah, coming up very soon. Okay, we're going to put 60 seconds on the clock. Virginia gives you the clues to movies. She cannot use any of the characters' names, any of the actors' names, or any of the words from the title of the movie. Okay, we got 60 seconds, and your time begins now.
You wear this on your wrist to tell you the time.
A clock? I mean, a watch?
Yes. Pass on that one. Pass on that one. There's three of them. They're female. They're crime-fighting. It was a TV show back in the 70s, and then it was movies.
Powerpuff Girls?
Pass. Pass on that one. The sky is falling. The sky is falling. It's a poultry, and it's not big.
Oh, I know this one.
It's not big. What's the
little
opposite of
something?
Little poultry.
Oh, good God. I don't know.
Pass. If it's a car that goes really fast, they call it a what? Brum, brum. I'm revving my engine. I'm driving this
car.
Pass. Pass on that one. If you get a hit by a bolt from the sky, you've been what?
Crush? Squish?
What happens when the bolt comes from the clouds and hits you? You're what?
Mm. Oh, a lightning strike.
Oh, struck by lightning was the one we were looking for there. Okay.
Told me what he said.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll see if that holds up. You got one.
There's a chance.
Yes, there, Jasper. Let's see how that goes. Very
emotional
round. Some of the
ones you missed, Charlie's Angels, Chicken Little, and Hot Rod.
Okay.
It was a rough round. Okay. I think she had too much going on.
Why do you say that?
I thought it was very quiet over there.
Ding, 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 ding. I thought a train was coming through.
Girl, the bright line's coming.
Get off the tracks.
Move.
Okay, let's see how Jerry from Royal Palm does here with our current champion and leader, Suits. Hello, Jerry.
Hey, let's keep the streak going, Suits.
Let's do it, man. Let's just not drop an F-bomb, all right?
You got it. We won't keep that streak going.
Okay.
Okay, Suits giving the clues to Jerry. 60 seconds on the clock, and our time begins now.
Pass. Okay, this is when you're playing hide-and-seek. What do you say when you start looking for people? If they are good to go, or maybe they aren't good to go?
Ready or not?
Yep. This is a horse. It is, you get these, it's like a little bit of bread thing. It's a famous horse, the ocean, and then, yep. If you fall off a ship, you've gone what?
Overboard.
Yep. If you are trying to make sure your dog is good with going outside and using the bathroom, what do you call that when the dog knows to go outside and use the bathroom? You have a term for your home and not fixed. Pass. This is something you would say when the waves are good and you want to go on your board and ride the waves.
Surf's up.
Yep. This is somebody who paints a picture.
The painter. Artist.
Yep. This is somebody you hire to kill somebody. They're a professional.
Hitman.
Yep. In tennis, when you're at the last point, or pass, I can't say point. This is somebody who sings a...
Okay.
Suits is on fire.
That is
great job, man.
Six spot.
Dang.
Pretty nice round,
Jeremy.
That
was awesome.
Pretty nice round.
Wow, that belt must be safe.
Guess we'll find out here. Michelle is on from Loxahatchee to try to shock the world with the bird here.
Michelle?
Hey, good morning, guys.
Michelle, nobody thinks we can do this. Nobody thinks there's a shot.
We got this, Jason.
Okay, I like that.
We got it. Okay. We got it.
She's confident. I like positive people. It's so nice.
Okay, 60 seconds are on the clock here in the No Name Movie Game. Jay Bird and Michelle, your time begins now.
This is a opposite of woman, and it's somebody that comes in there and destroys all of the buildings. They're just breaking it all down.
Man.
Yeah.
Man.
But think you're just that pass. I bought this and I brought it back from you. I bought you a blank. Not a present, but a thing you have holding your heart near and dear. Pass.
Pass.
Caffeine and cancer sticks.
Cigarettes?
Okay, but caffeine. Blank and cigarettes. Caffeine.
Coke?
No.
Caffeine. Soda.
No. Think Sanka.
Coffee.
Yes. Put it together.
Coffee and cigarettes?
Yes. A John Mayer song. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. The moon. You're floating.
I have no idea.
Okay,
no
pass.
Idea.
Me and you are going out to Lauderdale.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
You had said God, cigarettes on coffee and cigarettes.
I did?
Yeah.
Well, no,
she said cigarettes.
She said cigarettes
it.
First.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she said it first.
Are you okay. really trying to get me for 1 point?
We got to give them that
oh,
point.
Oh, my God.
If you say cocaine, yeah, you got
to
get the point.
At least one.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, we'll give you one.
Should I take away my point?
I just heard cigarettes. I can't see what the movie is. I don't know. I'm trying to follow it all along and make sure our contestants aren't dropping F-bombs. So there's a lot going on here. I apologize. I don't want to take away that 1 point.
It's busy.
Yeah. I need that point.
Okay, all right. Then you can have it.
To get through the weekend, he needs that.
So he only lost by 5.
36. Oh, yeah.
Aww.
I'm sorry. The problem
okay.
is me.
Well, there you
oh,
go.
Sorry, Jason.
I'm sorry.
No, you guys did great.
Nice try there. Suits continues his domination. He is going to remain the champ and moves to 5 wins on the year.
Not gonna lie, when someone puts a 6th spot on the board, it's very disheartening going into that round.
It is. Even with cocaine and cigarettes, you can't beat them. You can't beat Suits.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. All right. Congratulations there, Jerry. Enjoy your win.
Great job, man.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You don't care.
He's gone.
He hung up already?
Near and dear to his heart, Kevin.
Yeah. I got better things to do. All right, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, we are really kind of in the heart of the best time of year, in my opinion, in South Florida, because there's so many great things going on. Spring training kicked off last weekend. This weekend, you've got the Cognizant Classic going on. Our big golf tournament is happening. The Rib Roundup is going on this weekend at the amphitheater. So what we're doing for the KVJ draft today, the best South Florida events. If it goes on in South Florida, you can draft it, and it can be from any time of the year. So it's our best annual events. That's what we're going to draft out next here on the KVJ Show.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike. You're up to speed for the most part. The only crash to watch for being reported on Lake Victoria Drive. Look for this one right at Golden River Drive. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
This is the day of the big sale at your gift shop.
Welcome in.
So this isn't just a big day for your business. It's a big day for the network keeping it all connected. That is, if it can handle the pressure.
Next in line, please.
So is it possible to get business internet you can really count on? It is. With 99.9% network reliability from Comcast Business. It's like this neat little bow.
Do you like that gift wrap?
Really ties it all together. Reliable internet for your business. It's not just possible. It's happening. Comcast Business. Powering possibilities.
Get started with internet and security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get an $800 prepaid card on a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call or go online today to switch to Comcast Business. INS 5524. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Eco bill and auto pay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medication called Revelex. It's proven to work. You've probably heard about semaglutide. It's got all the celebrity buzz, and it's FDA approved for weight loss. Well, Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide meds, and it comes in a full-strength daily tablet. So there's no needles, just results. And you're not going to be waiting to fill your prescription. There's no back orders. Get started on Revelex today and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs, all while eating a wide variety of foods. You can still enjoy cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Plus, Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts, so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. So schedule your appointment to get started on Revelex today. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. If you've been injured in a car accident, call America's largest injury law firm. For over 35 years, my mission has been to deliver more for our clients, to deliver more for you. If you or anyone in your family has been injured in a car accident, call us now, as the time to file a claim may be limited. Last year, more clients hired Morgan & Morgan than ever before, protecting America, fighting for you, Morgan & Morgan. Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Dr. Rosenthal just has that aura, that energy, that gentle spirit of confidence where you know you're in the best hands possible for your facial plastic surgery procedure. If you're thinking about anything, plastic surgery of the face, nose jobs, the rhinoplasty, also the eyelid lifts, the face lifts, the beautiful lift, the neck lift, he does it all and he's really good at faces. Dr. Rosenthal did my daughter's rhinoplasty. He also did my girlfriend's beautiful lift. It's an in-office facelift where they don't have to use general anesthesia. You're awake the entire time. You don't wake up groggy and all out of it like you would normally. It's just like you had a teeth cleaning and you had a facelift. It's amazing. It's called the beautiful lift, and Dr. Rosenthal does them. Set up your consultation today at rosenthal-md.com. That's rosenthal-md.com.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Mostly cloudy with areas of patchy fog, especially those inland spots. Otherwise, it is muggy. The few passing showers too possible this morning. Temperatures in the upper 60s throughout the morning. Heating up fast, though, into the low 80s this afternoon with partly to mostly cloudy skies. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation. The Crohn's and Colitis Foundation has been at the forefront of inflammatory bowel disease research and care for over 50 years. Learn more about research, education, and support at Crohn'sColitisFoundation.org.
Dunkin' Donuts, the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF. What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Ton of great things that you can get if you listen to Danny and Megan this afternoon. The prizes are pretty bountiful. They have got tickets to Jennifer Lopez at the Kaseya Center in Miami on June 28th. They've also got tickets to Universal Orlando. So be here this afternoon when they are on 97.9 WRMF for your chance to win. All right, time for a KVJ draft here today with so many awesome events going on this weekend and this month. We're going to be drafting out the best South Florida events for the entire year. I got everybody's draw right now. I'm just waiting for you. Burr, what did you draw? What card?
Ooh, a 10.
Okay, you got a 10. Okay, so you got a second pick here. Virginia has got overall first, then it's me, Suits, and then Denny's is got that last place position. We do a snake draft, so it starts at the top, goes to the bottom, and works its way back up. So, Virginia, you have the overall number one pick. What do you think is South Florida's best event?
This one's tough, because I got a bunch of them that I go to that I love, but I think my number one pick, I don't got nothing to do with it, Sunfest.
Okay.
I think it is the top South Florida festival.
You think it's the overall number one thing?
I do. I'm picking Sunfest.
Wow.
And you can suck on that.
Wow. Okay. All right, let me see here. Boy, there is so much stuff to choose from. A lot of pressure here, but I am going to...
I think is Bird.
Oh, Bird, sorry.
Damn.
Bird, go ahead.
Oh, he skipped you.
He tried to take my point away from the movie game. Now he's trying to skip me.
I got it out for you today.
What did I do to you, dog?
I know, I don't know.
The message is clear.
Oh, yeah. Loud and clear. Crystal. I'm going to go. I can't believe it. I'm going to go... Feast of Little Italy.
Oh, yeah.
Very disrespectful from Virginia.
You have to pick that. Wow. You're Italian. You better pick that.
That's why you didn't go with the Virginia?
Well, I'm not Italian, but it was on my list.
Okay.
I mean, she kind of helps run it. I don't know. That's a little disrespectful, kid.
I'm going to go with South Florida Fair. Now, a lot of people go to that every single year. It's a big fan favorite. All right, Suits, it's over to you. What are you going to pick for South Florida's best event of the year?
I'm kind of surprised this one's still out there. I'm going to take Tortuga.
Okay. All right. I thought about the Tortuga, but I know it's country.
It's too expensive.
It's a little polarizing. Mm-hmm.
So you kind of think Suits has a terrible pick there.
I thought about Tortuga, but that's why I didn't go with it, because I was like, I didn't know how to play.
Sounds like Ralston's got some beef with you too, Suits.
Come for everybody now. All right, Denny's, what do you think? What is your pick for the best South Florida event? You got the next two.
All right, I'm going to do Miami SuperCon. It has all the Comic-Con stuff, all the collectibles.
Oh, cool. I never even heard of that.
Because, Kevin?
Kevin, it's Dork Fest.
You do have, you have three dorks on the show. Me, Denny's, and Suits are dorky people.
Okay. Number two, I'm going to take Ren Fest. I'm doing all the dork stuff.
I love it, dude.
Okay. All right. Yeah. There you go. All right. Suits, it goes back up to you. What are you going to pair with your Tortuga?
I'm going to take Fantasy Fest in the Keys.
Oh, okay. All right.
That's a good one.
Yeah, it is a solid, solid pick. Okay, let me see. It goes back to me, and I'm going to go with an event that just happened, and I think it is getting bigger every single year. The crowds for the Lake Worth Street Painting Festival, I think, were the biggest I ever saw just this last weekend. It's a fun event. I'm going to go with that. All right, Bird, back to you. What do you think? South Florida's best event.
Only talking about the taste of Little Italy.
Oh.
Going to feast, there. Doing the taste.
Yeah.
You're trying to make up for being a bad Italian the rest of the year?
Hey, I mean, says I'm a bad Italian?
Every Italian has to vote for you.
Yes, that is true.
I'm going for the Italian vote.
Uh-huh. All right, Virginia, you get the next two picks. What are you going to put with Sunfest?
With Sunfest, I am also going to have the Crawfish Fest, which comes up April 13th and 14th.
Okay.
Which I am very excited about. You know I love crawfish.
All right.
And then I am picking, it's happening not this weekend, but next weekend at Abacoa, Irish Fest, Saturday and Sunday. Nobody drinks like the Irish.
Okay.
They know how to get it.
All right. There's Virginia. Her list is done. Bird, what are you going to do to wrap up yours?
Pizza Fest.
Pizza Fest.
To be determined. In the future. KVJ, baby.
We've talked about doing a Jaybird Pizza Fest.
I know. Great idea.
It would be huge. You would dominate.
Okay.
I am going to go with... Hold on. Oh, gosh. I'll go with Martin County Fair.
Martin County Fair. Okay.
Is that South Florida?
Martin County?
Yeah.
We'll count that. Absolutely.
Definitely.
Yeah.
We'll go with that. Martin County Fair.
That's a terrible pick, by the way.
It goes off up
well,
there.
I was going to do Crawfish Festival in Virginia just I thought she forgot about it. So
No.
I panicked. I didn't know what else to pick. Damn it.
And you're performing at Crawfish Fest.
Oh.
Okay. I think that for my final pick here, I am going to go with the Cognizant Classic going on this weekend. I'm going to go ahead and put that down. That is a good time out there in the Bears Trap.
Formerly known as the Honda Classic.
Yeah,
the big golf tournament.
I'll put that on there so people aren't confused. All right, Suits, what is your final pick?
I got a couple here I want to narrow it down.
I think I'm going to go with Art Basil, do a bit of a well-rounded list. Got some art, got some country.
You mean Art Basil?
I thought it was Basil.
Basil's delicious.
They mix cooking and art together.
Yes. Okay.
Man, I can't tell you how many times I promoted that wrong on the radio.
Oh.
Don't worry about it, baby. And finally, Denny's. What are you going to choose for your third and final pick?
For the final one, I'm going to go the Night of the Krampus. It's at the American German Club.
Oh, yeah.
For Christmas, instead of St. Nick, you get the Krampus, right. The evil St. Nick.
That's kind of fun.
It's super fun. You get real hammered, and he comes out, and you get photos with him. He looks like a giant ghoul.
I love it. I don't think you're getting any votes on it, but I do love it, and I want to thank you.
I hope it turns people onto it.
You keep me safe from last place.
Virginia had Sunfest, the Crawfish Festival, and Irish Fest. Bird, his best South Florida events was Feast a Little Italy, Taste a Little Italy, and the Martin County Fair. I went with the South Florida Fair, the Lake Worth Street Painting Festival, and the Cognizant Classic. Suits got Tortuga Music Festival, Fantasy Fest, and Art Basil, Miami Beach.
Suits is winning.
Obviously going to win.
There's no way he doesn't get number one.
Suits is number one, you think. Okay. Denny's has got Miami Supercon, Renfest, and the Night of Krampus. Okay.
Look, it's a true to his heart list.
That's what I'm doing. Yeah. Okay. Every time I pick the big players, it just doesn't pan out for me. So, you know what? Going from the heart today.
Okay, so let's see. We did not get anything like, unfortunately, Rib Roundup didn't make it.
Oh, dude, what am I doing?
Yeah.
I thought about it.
Oh, that was stupid. Can I please change my nope. Martin County?
Yeah.
Fair? Yeah. What am I doing over here?
It's in stone now.
I was too busy with rage in my heart trying to take Virginia's Crawfish Festival. I was blinded by rage.
Yeah. nobody took Ultra. Nobody took Rolling Loud, some of those festivals. Nobody took any of the boat shows. That didn't go. Let me see. Nobody took a Cayocho. That didn't go. Miami Open, Miami Grand Prix, South Beach Wine and Food Fest, or the Palm Beach Food and Wine Festival. So neither of those went. So.
Pride Fest, where we're going to be at the end of the month.
Right. Absolutely.
We kind of collectively blew it.
Boat parades. There's just so many.
I feel confident.
I had them. Yeah. It's just there's just a lot.
I mean, Kevin's list didn't suck as bad as me and Denny's, but it ain't that great either.
I love my list.
Your list. I think my list is on point, dog.
I think Seuss is going to destroy all of us.
I don't know, Martin County Fair.
Yeah. I might get laughed.
Yeah, I know you want to throw shade at everybody else's list.
That's what you got to do when you fail so bad.
You got to try to take somebody down.
Yeah. All right, if you want to vote on who you think drafted out the best three events, it's going to be posted on our Instagram, Facebook all throughout the weekend. We'll let you know the winner coming up Monday morning about 7:35. Do you think it's weird to go to a concert all by yourself? One girlfriend's questioning her boyfriend who wants to do that this weekend. We'll tell you about it coming up next. Is it weird going to a concert alone? Got an email from one of our KVJ Nationers, mail at kvjshow.com, who's asking the question because her boyfriend's going to be doing that. She said, I heard you guys were giving away tickets to the Rib Roundup that's happening on Saturday last week, and my boyfriend heard it too and was trying to win your tickets, but he didn't. And he wanted me to go with him, but I hate country music and I don't eat ribs. Okay, well then, yeah, there's not.
That might not be the festival for you.
Probably not for you. He's also the only one in his friend group that likes country. Now, he mainly wants to see that Lainey Wilson that is a headliner. And even though I knew he wanted to go, I didn't think he'd go out and buy a ticket all by himself. So I told him I would have sucked it up and I would have gone with him, but he told me that he didn't want me to be miserable or hear me complaining the entire time that I wasn't having a good time. So I was hoping to actually spend Saturday with him, but apparently I'm spending it by myself or with a friend because he is going to go to this concert by himself. But that's kind of weird, isn't it? I mean, who goes to a concert by themselves? Do you find this odd?
No.
No, I think we need to normalize people doing stuff by themselves. Like, if you can't find somebody that you'd really enjoy hanging with at the concert, go and enjoy the music.
I feel just like him. The idea of somebody doing something for me and they're miserable and they're only doing it just because they're making me happy. To sit at a concert knowing you're not enjoying it, I would not want to put someone through that. It would make me not enjoy the concert knowing you're not enjoying it. And listening to music alone is not a weird thing. People do it all the time.
Yeah, so you think there's nothing at all odd?
Zero. He's doing you a favor. You hate country music. Right. No one likes it. He's trying to be cool about it.
It sounds like he did the right play. If you wanted to go.
And now you're kind of making him feel bad about it. Yeah. It's a breakup.
It's going to be a great show going down tomorrow. Lainey Wilson, like I said, she is arguably the biggest name in country music now. Just a whole year of nothing but wins.
I'm over here asking more questions about the ribs. I'm figuring
ribs
out.
Are great too.
Well, I'm just trying to think, is it restaurants or are people at their houses making these ribs?
Mainly restaurants.
How do you get into this thing? I mean, is there a criteria? Are there five rib places that tried out and didn't get an entry?
They probably go to a lot of the rib restaurants and see if they want to be a part of. It's probably an in-depth sales thing. I can break it all down for you. I just probably go out and send them emails and call them and say, hey, do you want to be a part of it?
People take rib making very seriously.
Yeah. It's more of what I've noticed. It seems like restaurants than it is an individual competition of who's got the best ribs. So that's pretty much what I've noticed out there. But I don't know the criteria, Burr, but we can... It's within our own company, so we can get all the information for you.
Believe me, these are things people want to know, Kevin.
Okay. Well, I want to see how much you guys know about country music. I got a round of country song fill in the blank. You know, country music has some very interesting titles. And you got to tell me here what this song title is. I'm going to give you multiple choice, too, because I know you guys aren't big country fans.
Well, I don't like being painted with that brush.
We love 90s country.
Do you want me to give you a current country quiz?
You can give me a current any music quiz. I'm going to fail it, no matter what genre it is.
Okay, so what do you think belongs in the blank here, Virginia? Mississippi blank. Is it A, Mudhens, Squirrel Revival, or C, Flapjacks? What do you think the correct answer is that belongs in the blank? Mississippi Mudhens, Mississippi Squirrel Revival, or Mississippi Flapjacks?
Sing it in your head. Mississippi Mudhen, Mississippi Flapjack.
I like Mudhen, Kev.
You're going to go Mudhens? I know, it sounds great, doesn't it?
It does.
It sounds like a baseball team.
Oh.
It is Mississippi Squirrel Revival, B. Huh. I don't even know what that means.
I don't either.
I don't know what a Mississippi Squirrel Revival is, but I'm fascinated.
And you said that's a country lyric?
It's it's a country song.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It's a country song. Mississippi Squirrel Revival. All right, Bird, fill in the blank here. I don't look blank. I don't look blank. Is it A, at your sister anymore? Is it B, I don't look back because there's a mullet there now? Or is it C, I don't look good naked anymore?
I don't look good naked anymore.
That is correct.
Yeah.
He felt the personal connection.
Oh, I hear you. I think you might get country.
I live it.
Okay, Virginia, what about this? Fill in the blank here on this country song. Would Jesus blank? Is it A, wear a Rolex, B, beer bong a 12-pack, or C, drive an El Camino?
Show me drive an El Camino.
Virginia's going to go drive an El Camino, and survey says...
Damn it.
No, it's wear a Rolex. Oh, man, that's some shaming right there.
That sounds like...
Would Jesus wear a Rolex?
That sounds like that could be a sassy country song, maybe?
We're talking to you, Joel Osteen.
Yeah, right?
Is it sassy country? I don't know.
Okay, Bird, fill in the blank here. Country song, fill in the blank. Who's gonna blank? What belongs in the blank? Is it A, skin your deer, B, mow your grass, or C, bail out your brother?
I think it is who's going to mow your grass, and it's kind of like a double entendre kind of a, yeah, there's
it is.
Yeah.
Look at Bird, he's crushing this. He's unstoppable, Virginia.
I know, I'm impressed.
Okay, final one for you, Virginia. Country song, fill in the blank. First redneck blank. Is it A, to graduate from high school? Is it B, to drive an electric car, or C, on the internet?
Show me electric car.
Gonna go electric car.
Man, you fight country.
I'm terrible at this.
First redneck on the internet.
Oh.
C is the correct answer. Bird for a perfect score. Fill in the blank on this country song. I wouldn't take her blank. Is it A, to a dogfight, B, to a cockfight, or C, anywhere but Arby's?
Oh, boy, it's a tough one because I know they like cutesy, fun restaurant stuff in country songs.
Like Applebee's on a date night. Yeah.
I have one example of that. What was the first one, just out of curiosity?
To a dog fight. I wouldn't take her to a dog fight. What do you think?
That sounds... I'm going to go Arby's for some reason.
You're going to go anywhere but Arby's. I wouldn't take her anywhere but Arby's. Your first miss, that's the one I wish it was. It's to a dogfight.
Huh.
Don't even understand that.
That sounds kind of serious.
Yeah, it does sound very serious. I thought we stopped doing all that kind of stuff. All right, well, if you'd like to get your tickets, the Rib Roundup, you can still jump on a newcountry1031.com or check out the secondary ticket markets. They've got some tickets for the country show with Lainey Wilson, Nate Smith, Warren Ziders, and Rodney Atkins tomorrow at the I Think Financial Amphitheater.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, coming up in your Dirt of the Day, Jesse Smollett. Remember him?
Oh, yes.
He just completed something kind of big. What do you think it is? What does he have to say? I'll share with you coming up in your dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-860-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. No major incidents reported at the moment on 95 or the Turnpike. Just a little under speed right now on both sides of the Turnpike between Boynton Beach Boulevard and the West Palm Beach Service Plaza. There is a crash to watch for, however, that is tying you up on 45th Street. Look for this one in the area of Australian Avenue. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Demand Dave! 844-411-1LAW. Demand Dave! For a car accident or slip and fall. Need a personal injury lawyer? Come rest and come rest. 844-411-1LAW. DemandDave.com!
Coconut shrimp is back at Pollo Tropical. We're serving a perfectly golden, sweet, and savory coconut shrimp in a bowl, platter, or as a side with our pineapple rum sauce. Don't miss out on coconut shrimp at Pollo Tropical. Try it today.
When it comes to staying ahead of your medical issues, there's no better way to do it than to do what Kevin and I did and go down to Life Imaging FLA and do that free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements. They can tell you everything going on the inside, and that's a big deal. If you have a blockage, don't you want to know about it?
Yeah, you really should, because the scary thing is one out of three people are going to be dying from heart disease, but with one free heart scan in just 10 minutes, with no dyes or no need to undress, you can get the answers you need. It's just a few minimum requirements. This is a $699 value.
And 80% of the people that do it, like Kevin and I did, get back a score of zero blockages. And then they're like, whew, they have a sigh of relief. But if you have a blockage, wouldn't you want to know?
Yeah, and you can even check out their cancer screening and their virtual colonography. All you've got to do is from your cell, call pound 250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's pound 250, keyword free heart scan.
I'm what you might call very good at hide and seek. This one time, my parents had to round up the whole neighborhood to track me down. It was a mess. A lot of tears. Well, now that we got Xfinity, we have Wi-Fi all over the house, including all my favorite super secret hiding spots. So I can kill time in here by streaming my shows and...
Ha! Found ya.
The heck? How?
You left to find my tablet on.
This generation, ruining the game with their performance enhancers.
Get wall-to-wall Wi-Fi from Xfinity for a reliable connection throughout your home. Now through March 5th, get gig speed internet for $35 a month for 12 months when you add unlimited mobile. Plus, get Wi-Fi equipment included for 2 years. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless plan, auto pay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra and may change. Gig speed Wi-Fi requires gig internet and Xfinity gateway. After 12 months, internet increases to $60. After 24 months, regular rates apply. Xfinity Mobile requires Xfinity internet. Actual speeds vary.
Is committed to supporting those who uphold the Western way of life. Denim plays a major role as a robust material that holds strong in a rugged environment. Since 1947, the Wrangler Authentic Western Jeans have brought long-lasting denim to all who embrace the cowboy lifestyle. Boot Barn is proud to support this bold legacy, one that's just as iconic now as it was then. Wrangler at Boot Barn.
Oh, I'm so sad. I have to give back the EV9 today. I got to drive it back to Greenway Kia and give it back. Boy, it's been a fun week. I have loved this fully electric EV9. They are restocked with so many at Greenway Kia. Go check out the inventory. The EV9, the EV6, the Tellurides, the Sportages, the K5s, the Hybrids, and the Fortes. They've got them all, and they need to move them. You get in there, and you get a great deal at Greenway Kia on a totally redesigned car. If you think you know the Kia brand and you haven't driven a Kia lately, you don't know the Kia brand. You got to go see the innovation, the technology, the advancements, the luxury. Greenway Kia's got them. And if you're making $350 a week, they want to approve you. So just call 1-800-NEW-KIAS and go see my friends at Greenway Kia. Check them out online, KiaWestPalmBeach.com.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Strax Aesthetics, the foremost name in cosmetic surgery, is now offering unbelievable pricing for tax season. Breast dogs from under $100 per month, tummy tucks from under $200 per month, and gastric sleeves for excess weight loss as low as $300 per month for qualified patients. All surgeries are performed by renowned board-certified surgeons. Strax guarantees to beat any quote by comparable surgeons. And Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price for services. View surgeon bios and past work by visiting StraxPlastic.com or call 954-749-3040 for a free consultation.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at BirchLane.com.
When it comes to relocation, this is one of those things that you gotta call in the experts. Please don't try to do it all yourself. For everything under the sun, we know to go to Greek. Good Greek Enterprises can handle every detail of your relocation, from real estate services to moving and storing to insurance to your mortgage to your refinance. They do every now. Give it all to Good Greek.
Yeah, and I tell you, when you give it to Good Greek, they're gonna take care of it and they're gonna run with it and they're gonna do it right. They're going to take the stress off of your shoulders. They do everything that you need. like being punctual, showing up on time, taking care of your stuff, and making your move super easy.
And if you got junk all around your backyard, your front yard, they can get all that junk out of for you, too. Junk removal is a big thing.
It is a big thing. They can take all your stuff and put it in storage at hurricane season if you've got a bunch of stuff in the yard. Like, they do it all. Big or small, take it to Greek, because it's all good Greek to us. Go to goodgreek.com.
Experience the Anninger and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, did you see that Jussie Smollett is doing the work, y'all?
He is.
Yes. He just finished a five-month rehab stint. And I was like, whoa, 5 months? Okay. And then I read a little bit further. It was an outpatient program. He was just going to therapy.
He is extra.
Oh, he is so extra.
He is extra.
If you put it out there that you just completed 5 months in rehab, I'm like, whoa, that's crazy. 5 months. No, he wasn't in 5 months of rehab. It was outpatient. So he's just going to therapy every day.
Well, it's not like him to distort the truth or fib.
He continues to try to get out of his 150-day sentence. Now, he is waiting right now to see if the Illinois Supreme Court will make his sentence stand, and then that means he has to turn himself in to go to jail for lying to the court about him being abused and going through all kind of stuff. But he says that it was because of alcohol and drugs, and that now that he's passed the rehab hurdle, and staying sober is his main focus, and he'll never do anything like that again because now he realizes that was all just because he was intoxicated.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay. So he made all those bad decisions?
Yes.
Okay. He probably should stop talking.
Well, Tom Brady just did something amazing. We talked about it way earlier in the show, but in case you missed it, he just ran a faster 40-yard dash at the age of 46 than he ran back in the NFL Combine when he did it 24 years ago.
It really is crazy.
Oh, my gosh.
Absolutely insane. Here's a little bit of the audio, which I'm sure is a commercial for his TB12.
24 years ago, I ran a 5.28 40-yard dash. If we have some extra time, maybe we give the 40 one more shot. Let's see if we can level up. Let's go.
Come on, go.
5.18. 5.12 on the second.
If you do that 25 years ago, you get drafted.
That was fun. Next year, it's going to be faster.
Wow. Okay.
So I guess the moral of the story is drugs work.
Yeah, drugs work. And that whole cell rejuvenation stuff, either by using your own plasma or by using stem cells, it's very expensive, but y'all, it works.
You know, you always hear these crazy things on people's podcasts. I forget who it was. It was some doctor talking about, oh, we're going to have the technology eventually to be able to live to about 130 and live with no pain. You're going to be living a healthy life just through medicine.
He's running faster than he did when he was in his 20s.
It's crazy, right?
Do you think medicine will get us to that point where we are?
If it keeps going on this pace, yes.
Where you can run fast in your 80s?
I saw a chick on Extra or Access Hollywood, one of those shows, turning 100. TikTok Granny, they called her. She was turning 100, and she was shaking that thang. She was, like, getting down and shaking it all around, and she is literally turning 100.
She's wow. Single?
She didn't look bad. For 100, look, y'all, the hundreds now look like they're in their 70s.
I think if you're 100 and you're blinking, you look great.
Amen. And finally here, what's going on with the royal family? Have you heard some of these conspiracy theories?
It's crazy.
Oh, I love a conspiracy theory. So there are a bunch of people over in England right now that say, we haven't seen Kate Middleton in months. What is going on? We think they killed her just like they did Princess Diana.
What?
Yeah.
that there are people that believe this conspiracy theory that she is not alive and they're hiding it and they don't want to say. Other people are saying, no, she just got bangs and she's waiting for them to grow out, which I think is hilarious.
Yeah, all the real things that are going on here. Yeah, some people were thinking that she's gone. It's like, because a lot of people think that Princess Diana was taken out by the royal family.
I don't disagree with that.
And so they're like, okay, what did she do? Maybe they're responsible.
She's been a good soldier. Like, why don't she doesn't speak out? She just follows right in line with the whole company mantra.
She doesn't speak out.
She does not speak out. She is not at all that person like Diana was.
Well, if they're going to take anybody out currently, they're going to take out Prince Harry's wife.
Yeah. Oh, without a doubt. Meghan Markle seems like the one that they would want to snipe.
Right.
And she'll taunt them, too.
So stay tuned. We'll keep you posted. She hasn't been seen in months.
Okay.
And that's what's going on in your dirt.
It's time for viral audio.
Hey, yeah, beautiful hair.
They can't hear me because they're listening to Kids Bop.
We got weights and fits.
There we go.
Got some new music today. Cardi B has got a new freestyle out. It's called Like What that you can check out. She's also got the video to go with it as well.
Classy in a got that money, get it spun. Like what? Like a coach bag, baby, this ain't what you want. If I ask for it, I wanna hear is yes. Bitch said she wanna be my op, God bless. Look, I ain't even got dressed. Any help that I took, come after YS, oh man.
What do you think about that, Virginia? You like some Cardi B?
I do. I like it. I'll have to get into it a little bit.
Okay.
Taste it this weekend.
Okay. Kacey Musgraves, she is going to be on Saturday Night Live coming up this weekend. And she also just announced that she's coming to Hard Rock Live on November 30th of this year. And she's got a new song that she dropped as well, Too Good to Be True.
Please don't make me regret. Open it up, that part of myself. And I've been scared to give again. Be good to me, and I'll be good to you. But please don't be too good to be true.
I like that. Yeah, that's she's good.
She reminds me of a singer. I don't know if you know who this is. Her name's Mindy Smith. Does that ring a bell at all?
I don't think I know Mindy Smith.
No. It's kind of like, it sounds country, but it's not completely country. Yeah, it's like singer-songwriter.
Yeah, Kacey Musgraves, I think, is probably more singer-songwriter than she is country, but they put her in country because they don't know what to do with her.
That's peaceful right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, she has really I good like stuff. That. Yeah, she's very good. You might like some Kacey Musgraves. Also, Charlie XCX, she is back with a new track called Von Dutch. Not as peaceful, Stacey Musgraves. Yeah, so that's a little busy.
That's a
it's
rough
not a
one,
great,
dog.
It's not a really good song, actually. I was like, that's not great. Paula Cole, remember her? Where Have All the Cowboys Gone?
Yes.
Yeah, new music from her out today. Kaiser Chiefs, an alternative band, has got new stuff. Liam Gallagher used to be in Oasis, but he hates his brother so much he won't work with him anymore. So he's with John Squire from the Stone Roses now.
It's crazy how much they hate each other still.
One of them was just out this week talking smack about the other one, saying he's the problem.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get it back together.
It was Liam. He was talking about Noel. He said, yeah, he's ruining
it. He won't do it.
Thing.
He's ruining it.
Yeah. At that age, how can you not put the past behind you? And I even found out why they don't talk a lot. He had said something about his daughter at one point.
Okay.
And
who had?
The one that's always sassy said something.
Yeah, Liam. It seems Liam. Like Liam is it. And I think Noel's just like, I don't want to deal with you, man. And like, you're just too much. And, like, shut up.
And Noel got mad at what Liam said about his daughter. And then Liam didn't take it back. He's basically saying, it's not really that offensive. So I don't know why he's being such an offensive little bitch about it.
Well, you said something bad about your niece.
Liam has always got something bad to say about everything. They were just, you know, nominated, Oasis was, for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and all he did was just, you know, F off to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and I don't want it, and screw you guys. It's just like everything he says is just, every time he opens his mouth, it's just garbage. And
everyone's against you, dude. Everyone.
I'm kind of on Team Noel.
Me too.
Yeah, I think Liam's the problem. And Ministry has got new music out today as well. All right, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, we got some normal or nope for you. Is this normal or not? Somebody said, I want to know, is it normal to keep your soda or beer can tab up after opening it? Do you keep it up or do you put it flat?
Or do you rip it off?
Okay.
Some people rip.
That feels like that's the minority choice. It feels like that's not normal.
If you're very aggressive and you have meat hooks, maybe. Maybe you accidentally rip it off trying to open it.
I'm just, I might be a ripper.
You open everything like a bear.
Okay, all right,
All right, we'll run through that and a couple of your other thoughts as well coming up in minutes right here on the KVJ Show.
I never knew that everything was falling through, that everyone I knew was waiting on a cue to turn and run when all I needed was the truth. But that's how it's gotta be. It's coming down to nothing more than apathy. I'd rather run the other way than stay and see.
Okay, what do you think? Normal or nope here? What are the odd little quirky things that we all do? We'll give you a ruling if what you're doing is normal or no. This person wants to know, keeping soda or beer can tabs up in the upright position after opening them? Or do you push it backwards? Or a lot of people were texting in saying, you know, they're actually designed for you to flip over and around over the hole and then put a straw through the tab itself.
Ooh. How am I this old and just learned that?
Right, huh? How about that for an eye-opener?
What just happened?
Oh, my gosh. What? I cannot wait to open a soda now.
I know,
I'm
right?
So excited.
Go get us a soda out of the vending machine.
Do we have straws?
Yeah, we do, all actually. Right. Oh, my gosh. I got to try this.
We also have to get ourselves a vending machine because they gave that away like a year and a half ago.
That's right. Oh. We don't have one anymore.
So I push mine back. Does anybody here keep it in the upright position, the tab?
No, I push it back.
Bird, you rip it off?
Sometimes. I'm a fiddler. And I don't. You guys can, you'll notice it sometimes here in the studio. I'll just start fiddling with things. Sometimes I rip it off and don't even realize I'm doing it.
And then he cuts himself.
Yes, exactly.
Now he's bleeding in his Mountain Dew and has no idea why.
She ain't lying.
I don't think it's normal to keep it up because you push it back, obviously, because you don't want to get in the way while you're drinking, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, you can't chug if it's up.
Yeah.
Look, I used to be a ripper. Now I'm a hole person. I'm putting it through the hole.
You're going to do that,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, with the straw.
All straw?
Heck yes.
Okay. Is it normal to cover your plate when you heat up food in the microwave?
Yes, you should. Otherwise, it'll splatter all over the inside of the microwave.
Much like I am a ripper, I'm a splatter.
Just rip. Messes and destruction everywhere you go.
Rip and splat.
Dude, it's perfect. I live alone. I ain't got no one on my butt about anything.
Yeah. I used to. My family kind of grew up that way. We would put the paper plate over. Then I started putting the paper towels. So the problem with the paper towel, though, it kind of gets into your food. And then all of a sudden you got this mess when you take the paper towel out of your food. You just heat it up. So I let it splatter now.
I'm a little scarred, too, because I have accidentally put things in the microwave, i.e. Olive Garden breadsticks with the aluminum bag.
Fire starter.
All of a sudden you look over and you see explosions coming out of your kitchen. So I don't put any paper. I don't put nothing in the microwave. Just a plate and food.
Okay. What about this? Is this normal or no? This person says, I can only get out of bed if the minutes are even, like 6:14, okay? 6:15, absolutely not.
That's some OCD
stuff. That's weird. Yeah, you got to get over that.
I understand that. Ain't normal, right? I get it.
It's not
I totally understand
it.
That. Numbers is a weird thing for people of OCD.
Okay. How about this one? Do you do your O face in the mirror to see what your partner sees?
No.
I've seen my O face in the mirror, and it's horrific.
Wait, you got that ceiling mirror at Sasquatch Recordings?
No, but I think, you know, we've all been in a situation where there's been a mirror involved and you can see things going on.
I've never seen my O face.
Well, no one's shocked by that. Vanilla Vanna over here.
Have you seen your O face, Vanilla Kevin?
No, I don't think so.
You've given it on KBJ TV, though.
And yeah, right. I remember
you
we
even
did that
said
that one time.
It was your O face, and that was legit horrifying.
Horrifying.
Kevin, yes, it was. It's the last face you see after
those eyes.
Terrifying.
Okay.
Everybody wants that. I need to wear a mask when I make love. I need to do what Kanye does. You know, that'll be what I do from
a
now
ski
on.
Ski mask.
Would you be insulted?
With no
Kanye
eye holes.
Sex collection.
Are you insulted if your wife, the Mexican queen, goes, we can have sex, but you got to put this mask on.
You got to put a mask on. Hey, as long as I get it, I'm okay. Okay, is it normal for this one? Oh, man, this is rough. Somebody's texting this in. Normal or nope? My partner flosses his teeth and then eat what comes out.
Oh,
what?
No.
Normal or nope?
That's no, not that's not normal.
That is.
I mean, you know, hey, look, I guess you would have eaten it if it hadn't got trapped in your teeth. But yeah, it just doesn't feel like it. You should.
Don't do that. Don't ever do that. And don't let somebody see you do that.
That is a private thing we don't tell anybody about.
I remember one of the grossest things I ever saw was somebody took their floss and went,
what?
I was like, don't do that.
That's a punishment on this radio show.
Why would they do that? Who did that? We doxed that person, Kevin.
Somebody in my family did it years
ago. No.
It stood out to me.
We cannot.
Yeah. Is this normal or nope? When walking around a lake, I always walk to the right because the left feels wrong.
I'm not making fun of it because I got my own little quirks. I don't understand that, but I do understand.
Would you feel odd if you're approaching a lake, you see a lake, it's round, and there's a trail going around it. Does it feel weird if you take off to the left instead of the right?
Not for me personally, but I can see how it
could.
I think
I would go to the right 100% of the time.
So I'll go to the left.
No way.
I would go.
You go left?
I always go left.
That doesn't feel right. It feels like you're going upstream.
Right feels so wrong.
But it's the, no, that's the way traffic goes. Which way would you go, Virginia?
I would go left.
You would go left?
I would go left.
No
yeah.
way.
To me, I would go left because it's clockwise. I would not go counterclockwise.
We ain't driving. We're walking. It's different.
Okay, yeah, I'm just curious. If you were walking around a lake, would you go to the right or to the left to start?
When I was a kid, I had a problem with this because if I always had to go left. If I went right, that's where bad things would happen if you went right. If you always made you always go left. Do I sound crazy again?
Yes.
Oh, damn it.
Okay, I'll have Suits put up a KBJ TV poll. Yes.
I was talking for a long time and no one was saying anything.
We were just looking down like, oh boy, here
okay.
we go.
Go to YouTube, let us know if you're walking around a lake, do you start by going to the right or to the left? We'll find out what is normal next.
Let me tell you. Girl, you're my little boo thing. So I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Put a little gold in the teeth and the fit good, so I took the doors out the deep, okay. I see a brother holding your seat, no beef, but I'm trying to get the noise you release. Don't take my talking to your own. I can keep it chill like the Soviet blunt. I'ma keep it real when your man long gone. If you're looking for a friend and you got the wrong song, baby girl, what's good? What's with ya? If you book tonight, that's fiction. I'm outside, no pictures. You want me, go figure. To the back, to the front. You a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. Hey, to the back. To the front, you a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. You my little boo thing, so I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame, I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next, tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next, tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. So I don't give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know.
Okay, so we asked the question here. You can go to our YouTube. If you were walking around a lake, would you go to the left or would you go to the right to start? You guys both said you would go to the left.
Yeah.
I go to the right.
I go clockwise.
Yeah, I'm going, like, if I'm facing a lake and it's round and I'm going to start walking, I drop in, head right. 70% of people would go right. You guys are not normal.
Really?
Yeah.
Look.
So going left is not normal? It feels like the way you're supposed to go.
According to the poll, yeah.
You are preaching to the choir. I knew I wasn't normal.
See, I didn't know that.
That's your problem.
Yeah.
Just give in. Surrender to the fact that you insane, girl.
Yeah. I was telling you just yesterday that I don't know what it is, man. I get all these emails all day long from the Nextdoor app.
Yeah.
Send it to you. And I get caught up in the mundane drama that is happening in people's lives so intensely. And I just kind of love it because they're really not that important, but for some reason it's become important to me. So every time I see it, I've got to do like an update. And I just saw this just in from Kathy. She just said, I went to the Ark thrift store in Lake Worth Beach. I like going there. When I was looking at the artworks, I nearly spit. They have a piece of art priced at $3,900. I was so pissed, I walked out. Then I went to another thrift store a bit south, and their prices were awful. And guess what? I walked out, and I guess I'm done with thrifting. Oh my gosh, this just in, Kathy is done with thrifting.
What a thing that you did not have to post. I mean, that was so not worthy of a post. What an utter event.
I've done thrifting.
Poor Kathy.
Poor Kathy didn't let the whole world know that she's done with thrifting.
Yeah, I get it.
Oh my God, it's just over. All right, coming up here in a couple minutes, it is time for another round of Producer Denny's Knows When You're High. He has a superpower. He can tell when people are high and when they are not high. So if you are, call us. If you're not and you like to try to fool them, call us. 877-979-WRMF. 877-979-9763. We'll play next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Donald Trump has a court appearance this morning in Fort Pierce, and rolling roadblocks are now in effect for a large portion of 95 northbound, stretching from Forest Hill Boulevard to Orange Avenue in Fort Pierce. Make sure to stay off the highway this morning and expect heavy delays if you are anywhere near this. There's also a crash to watch for on Haverhill Road, this one right at Gun Club Road, and look for an accident tying you up on 45th Street at Australian Avenue. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
There is only one way to vote this year for the candidate that will make you laugh.
Okay, I'm in this strictly for the likes and the clicks.
That will make you sing.
He's the bloated orange lunatic.
The Emmy and Grammy nominated comedian, Randy Rainbow, for president.
Okay, cut the sh.
Friday, March 15th, Sunrise Theater. Tickets are on sale now at sunrisetheater.com. That's sunrise, TheAtre.com. Randy Rainbow in an all new musical comedy live performance.
Hey, West Palm Beach, looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
I was over there visiting yesterday with the girls at Begin Anew, picking up my medicine, feeling good, feeling great, feeling like I'm getting all of my hormones, my vitamins, my nutrients, my weight control under check. They do it all at Begin Anew. They can help you feel your best and live your best and get that youthful energy back. And they've got so many fun gadgets and gizmos for your skin. That Morpheus 8 system is unbelievable. They've got all the amazing lasers for hair removal and skin tightening. They've got those hydrafacials and photofacials. I loved the way my skin looked when I did the dermaplaning and the hydrafacial together. Oh, so dewy, so beautiful, courtesy of the amazing estheticians at Begin Anew. Go there and see them. Get your skin on point. Get your weight loss under control. They do it all. BeginAnewMed.com on Indiantown Road in Jupiter. BeginAnewMed.com.
Wondering what to do with your tax refund? Call Strax Aesthetics for cosmetic surgery done right. Prices guaranteed to beat any quotes from board-certified surgeons. Strax will discount any quote by at least 10% for procedures performed by April 15, 2024. Lowest prices ever on gastric sleeves for massive weight loss. Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price on fillers and wrinkle reducers. All procedures are performed by renowned board-certified surgeons. Visit StraxPlastics.com for surgeon bios and to see great results. Call 954-749-3040 to schedule your free consultation. And take advantage of Strax's tax season special.
Hey there, it's Randy for Sonovello. Why put yourself through another round of yo-yo diets and grueling exercise? Hit reset. Lose the stubborn fat in one visit to Sonovello. All that unwanted fat gone permanently on day one. The jeans you couldn't squeeze into, too big for you now? Schedule that free consultation. Learn all about microlaser fat removal. It's an amazing procedure. Excess tummy fat, sides, thighs, wherever you have stubborn fat, you just point to the problem areas and say, make this go away for good. It's truly that easy. Sonobello's made it even easier. Their once a year savings events going on. Sonobello, by the way, isn't some fad diet or boot camp workout. Sonobello is where you go to lose unwanted fat and inches permanently in one comfortable visit. So you ready to reset your shape? Schedule your free consultation now. Don't miss Sonobello's once a year savings event. Visit sonobello.com/radio. That's sonobello.com/radio.
When it comes to preventative medicine, I am all about knowing what's going on the inside before a major thing happens. And at Life Imaging FLA, they are saving people's lives by doing this free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements and telling them before they have a heart attack that they have a blockage. I love that.
Yeah, no, it's so key because honestly, in 30 to 40% of heart attacks, the first symptom is sudden death. You'll be saving your life. And it's not just about your heart scan. You can also ask them about their cancer screening and their virtual colonography.
It really is awesome. There's no dyes, no need to undress. It takes 10 minutes. Seriously, Kevin and I were in and out, and we had our results in hand, and I was so pleased. Zero blockages over here.
So Life Imaging right now is offering you a free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements. From your cell phone, call pound 250 and just say the keyword free heart scan. That's pound 250, keyword free heart scan from Life Imaging FLA.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
Mostly cloudy with areas of patchy fog, especially those inland spots. Otherwise, it is muggy. The few passing showers too possible this morning. Temperatures in the upper 60s throughout the morning. Heating up fast, though, into the low 80s this afternoon with partly to mostly cloudy skies. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by WeBuyAnyCar.com. Before you sell or trade in, find out how much your car is worth at WeBuyAnyCar.com. They make selling your car fast, safe, and fair. Get your free online valuation now at WeBuyAnyCar.com.
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath at ForYourRights.com.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Well, if you don't know, you can actually watch the KVJ Show. Right now, we are on YouTube. Pull us up on any screen that you got. It's super easy and awesome. You can also watch us on demand, too. Make sure you subscribe, ring that bell, and if you're in there watching us right now, do that little like thing. We definitely appreciate it. It is KVJ on YouTube.
He's producer Denny's, and he knows when you're high. Producer Dennis, and he's one hell of a guy.
He just continues to crush it. The numbers are staggering. Thank you very much to Hollywood Billy. Last year, Denny's was 86% at 44-7. This year, he's 14-1 at 93%. He's just getting better the longer he does it. How about that?
Honestly, huh? The streak was kind of good that it ended because 14-1 is very impressive. And when you have a streak, you can't live your life. Everywhere you go, people are hounding you, asking you about the streak.
So much pressure.
It's a lot.
You can see it's really weird.
Too much pressure to be a winner.
It is.
Yeah.
Be mediocre, kids.
Mediocre at best. You're good.
Okay, so here's what we've got. We've got a couple people here to test your superpower of knowing when people are high and when they are not high. You just need a few questions to kind of like get how they answer it, hear their voice, and then you'll determine if they are high or not. We start off here with Kiara from Stewart. Hello, Kiara.
Hi, good morning, guys.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you guys today?
Good. All right. Denny's is going to ask you a couple questions. Try to get a vibe on you if you are high or not.
All right. Kiara, first question. What would be the worst board game to live on?
Ooh.
I'd say Monopoly. It's too easy to get in jail in that game.
She's not lying.
Oh, wow. You can easily go to the clink in that.
And yeah. Baltic Avenue?
See, Mousetrap would suck. You're not paying attention. That cage comes down on you.
Ooh.
You're talking
too many boardwalk.
We love Monopoly.
Risk would be rough. Yeah, people attacking you.
Life would be rough.
Hungry, hungry hippos would be rough.
Oh, that would be hellish.
You're a marble.
Oh my gosh.
Unless you're that
old school mousetrap.
Oh, good call.
Mm-hmm. All right, she's thinking it through. Okay, what's your next question for Kiara Denny's?
All right, second question. Which Disney character gives the best back rubs?
Great question.
You know, I would definitely have to say Wreck-It Ralph. He's got those big arms with those big hands. He's got to have some kind of muscle behind it.
Huh. All right, Wreck-It Ralph.
Yeah.
I'm going to wreck it.
Huh.
I feel like Ariel gives a great massage.
What?
I don't know. She's
got little hands and, I mean... Not
she's
strong.
What, 13?
She's a little
No, she's
girl.
Not. Is she?
I think
tiny.
She's 12.
No, she's not.
We know you got a thing for her.
She's definitely underage.
I don't watch these cartoons. I'm talking adult Ariel.
Oh, yeah, right.
When she grows up.
We get it. That's okay.
Talking adult.
Awkward.
It's okay. Don't worry.
Wow.
Cut that in post.
Oh, man.
Tell us more about how you're looking for a schoolgirl.
Should have said Minnie Mouse.
All right. Final question or thing for you here. What's your best impression of Virginia?
Okay.
Oh, gosh, you're putting me on the spot. Oh, my God. Now I'm nervous.
Just say the line.
Oh, doing the dolphin?
No. I tried to do the cackle, but it came out too bad.
Oh, wow. Like, wah, okay. Wah, wah, wah. You stumped her on that one, Denny.
Just say you hate men.
Okay,
she's okay, getting
Cam.
It.
Yeah,
okay,
Cam.
All right, Denny's, what kind of vibe are you getting here from Kiara? Do you think she's high or not?
Kiara.
Fun.
Yeah.
Light.
Great attitude.
Mm-hmm.
Probably great with pets and people.
She's tricky. She's tricky. I was getting a little bit of a high vibe at first, but it kind of went away as we went on.
Okay.
Tricky.
Do I go with initial thoughts or do I switch it up?
I know it's very tough because Virginia made provolone pie and it's very pungent. It's very distracting.
I'm not going to lie. It's very strong.
It's very strong.
That provolone, though.
That's the vibe.
It's very intense. Oh, I did think she was. I'm gonna lean not high.
Okay, you're gonna say that Kiara is not high here, Denny's?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what your gut's telling you. Kiara, yeah. Are you high or not?
I'm so sorry, Denny's. Yeah, I am.
Oh, Denny's!
No.
Wow,
she got me.
She's good.
Got you.
She's good.
And she's fun?
I thought you were going to clock me with all the giggles. I'm so sorry.
No, you're awesome.
She got me.
This is a victory for you, girl. Don't be sad.
Damn it.
You beat him.
Incredible in all the years.
You slayed the dragon.
Finally got Denny's.
Damn it.
Okay, took down the champ. All right, Denny's, you start off. The first one is a miss.
Whoa.
Have we ever had two misses in a row?
I don't think we ever have had that.
Okay, let's see here. Andrew is on from Fort Pierce. Hello, Andrew.
All right, good morning, guys.
Morning. How you doing, Andrew?
Doing all right. How y'all?
Good. Okay. All right. Danny's going to try to figure out if you're high or not here. Gosh, he just missed. He's reeling from that, but he's got a couple questions here for you. Try to get his vibe. What do you want to ask Andrew, Denny's?
All right, Andrew. I'm still bleeding from that first one. Andrew, what would a monster eating a possum sound like?
I don't know.
Yeah, great effort. Yeah, that sounds like a Sasquatch.
Okay.
Let's see. Second question. What's your least impressive skill?
Least impressive.
Like you say it and people go, oh, wow, that's not that great.
I think it's like just separating my pinky toe from the rest of them.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
That is kind of tough.
All right.
I'm kind of envious, but.
Yeah. Not that impressive.
Not okay. That impressive.
Yeah. I'm not sure if I'm impressed at all.
Yeah. Send us a video.
Yeah. I want to see what this looks like.
Honestly, don't even worry about the video.
Here, spare yourself. Enjoy your weekend. Final one for you here. What's your best impression of Jay Bird?
Sasquatch is real.
Oh, okay. All right.
It's like a Timu Jaybird.
Yeah.
Like a Sasquatch instead of Bigfoot.
Yeah.
A little spin on it. Okay. Denny's, what kind of vibe are you getting off Andrew? Do you think this guy is high or not?
I'm not getting as much of a high vibe from Andrew.
Just don't think about losing. Don't think about the stakes.
Oh, my gosh. You couldn't lose two in a row.
Oh, my gosh, you guys.
On a Friday.
Oh, gosh. Lachlan, please not be listening.
Okay.
You know, last time I didn't go with my first thought. I'm going to stick with, I think that he is not high.
Okay, not high. Are you high, Andrew?
I am not.
Oh!
Yeah, I was going to say on the first one, Kiara, I heard you say, yeah, I'm getting a high vibe, and then you talked yourself out of your gut instinct,
You second-guessed yourself.
Yeah.
I guess I should always go with the first instinct.
And people were asking, too, there are times where we can have two people on the line that are both not high. There can be times where they're both high.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You don't know. Just because you get the first one, you don't, you automatically know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Luck
a lot of
draw.
Just trying to feel it out.
Yep. Okay. All right. There you go. You rebounded. At least you walk into the weekend with a win, Denny.
What was that, 15-2? Is that what that is?
Think so, yeah. Still good.
It's still good. It's still early in the year, though.
It is, yeah.
You know what's better?
Yeah.
16-1.
Oh.
Whatever.
Man, right?
I know you did.
Throw around cake.
Cold.
He was thrown off by the odoriferous provolone cake.
Fat Cold. Kevin, this provolone, can you smell that from there? This
I can smell it from outside the door.
I don't smell it at
smell
all.
That. And
you don't smell that?
It is potent.
The air has
been on it, I smell. But yeah, maybe I need to walk out of the room and come back in.
You might have the bronch COVID again.
I can smell the air.
I do smell it.
It's waft.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my gosh. It's so strong.
Baked provolone has a smell.
Does that look good to you?
No.
So what is that?
It looks a little thick. It's
provolone and
it's provolone.
Potatoes.
No. It's pastry, provolone, and apples and cinnamon.
It just looks. It's a little too heavy. I have to eat like a bird these days. It just looks a little heavy.
They got apples in it.
Yeah, I know. I'm sure it's delicious.
I like the poop too. I mean, that thing's like definitely.
You gotta take a video of yourself eating it and let me know if it's good.
How much of that would you eat in one sitting?
To your point, that would be
a square.
I would have to eat a small square unless I wasn't doing anything for the next day.
I was just saying, it looks like it might weigh on you.
Oh. Hey, you want to lay after you eat something like that.
Don't be a little girl.
I'm not.
Okay, yeah. Do it right, Bert.
Make a video of you eating it. I want to see if you like it or not.
I will.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Coming up here in a couple minutes, would you imagine that they would have problems at the Body Talk Strip Club in Port St. Lucie? Can you believe that? Yeah, there was an issue, an incident you're going to find out about in your whacked out news coming up next.
So So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it. When you're out looking like you do, but you can't hide it. No, put you in a frame. Oh, baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. Making me insane, you cannot be explained. Oh, you must be an angel. Every time the phone rings, I hope that it's you on the other side. I wanna tell you everything, everything that's on my mind. And I don't want any other guys taking my place, girl, I got too much pride. I know I may be wrong, but I don't wanna be right. Cause your lips were made for mine, and my heart would go flatline if it wasn't beating for you all the time. So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it. When you're out looking like you do, but you can't hide it. No, put you in a frame. Oh, baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. Making me insane. You cannot be explained. Ooh, you must be an angel. You in a frame, oh baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. Making me insane, you cannot be explained. Ooh, you must be an angel. Owner of my heart, tattooed your mark there for the whole world to see. You're the owner of my heart and all my scars. Baby, you got such a hold on me. So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it. When you're out looking like you do, but you can't hide it. No, put you in a frame. Oh, baby, who could blame you? Glad your mama made you. You must be an angel. Jealous, but I can't help it. I want every bit of you. I guess I'm selfish.
Ow! There's a lot of dumbass criminals to talk about, baby. It's the whacked out news. People breaking the law. Ha ha, fighting in the nude. Ha, drunk people pooping in the street. Ha ha, it's the whacked out news. So many people on meth. Ow!
Can you believe that there was an incident that happened at Body Talk, the strip club in Port St. Lucie?
Well,
crazy, right?
I mean, there's probably an incident every night at the strip club. That's just the strip club.
I feel like Body Talk's been around for a minute.
Oh, yeah. It's a classic joint. Classic joint. Well, there's some obnoxiously drunk dude that was there, and he was bragging about how much money he made.
There always is.
Though, despite the fact that he makes a ton of money, he's not sharing it with the dancers because he's not tipping at all. So, 28-year-old Victoria Jones, she's like, all right, dude, you make all this money. Why don't you tip? And he's like, there's no sign stating that it's mandatory.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. That's not the right thing to say.
Nah, Victoria kind of snapped on it. She picks up a stack of cash and slaps him upside the head with it.
Good for you. Hey, nothing's free, bud.
Yeah, a guy gets the cops involved. They come up to like, going, okay, did you slap him with a bunch of cash? And she's like, look, this guy has been in here insulting our dancers And she said, look, I just tossed the cash at him in a non-aggressive manner. But you know how that commercial goes where they pull the flag and then they do the replay of what happened?
Did they have video of
it? They did. And it shows she did slap him upside the head with the cash. So she's now facing charges of misdemeanor battery.
Free Victoria Jones.
I agree, right? Shouldn't we get those shirts going? Come on.
I will spearhead the GoFundMe to pay for her legal defense and fully get her exonerated. Because if this man is sitting in the front row dishing out nothing but insults, hasn't come off a single dollar bill.
This is a true freedom fighter.
He deserves to be smacked in the face with a bunch of money. He's lucky that's all he got.
Listen, Body Talk, if you are listening, you can't buy this kind of advertisement. Ride this wave.
Yeah. Free Victoria.
I agree. Yeah, she should be a local hero.
You are a hero.
Yeah.
I'm curious to see what the Body Talk looks like.
Well, let's go.
The little field trip?
I mean,
we all need to go and tip her because he can't.
Tell me that would not be a fun KVJ road trip. That'd us all so going to the body talk together. I am so in.
I am so in. I got to go up to the Treasure Coast on Saturday anyway. I'm doing another charity event for Folds of Honor, but that don't start till like 5 p.m. I can meet you there at like 4.
And all right, fundraiser starting.
And we're really not even going for carnal reasons. We're just kind of going there to hang out the Body Talk.
Yeah, and to make sure that she gets some tips.
Yeah, that's right.
Miss Jones, we're coming to tip you.
Yeah. Now, it doesn't specify that she was a dancer. I don't know if she's that or she's management. So.
Well, either way, she's defending her crew.
Right.
We like that.
Yeah. We do.
There's a driver that is recovering after spending 2 days on the side of a cliff after his car rolled several hundred feet down a California hillside.
Oh, my gosh.
He swerved to miss a deer and got ejected through the car's sunroof. How crazy is that?
That's tough. Why you wear your seatbelt.
Tough day for him. Great day for the deer.
Right.
The deer's like, whew.
That was close.
Did you see the viral video of Diana Schaefer's 12-year-old son that was riding in the back of her trunk?
I did.
Yeah. She tries to explain it because she did get arrested. She said there was a bassinet that was something she had picked up, and it wasn't broken down because it wouldn't fit in the back seat. So she told her son to sit on top of the folded down back seat and hold onto the bassinet. Well, at some point, without a seatbelt on, she says that her son made his way to the trunk, and then somebody who was driving behind them made a video of his head popping out of the open trunk as she's driving down the road. And she got arrested because of it and spent the night in jail.
So is she trying to defend it? Because it doesn't sound like a very good defense.
No, I think she's owning up to it. She said that she's thankful and not angry, but she is kind of explaining, saying, you know, because I think people are coming down and saying, how could you dare put your kid in the trunk and your kid could have fallen out the back and this and that? She's like, look, it really wasn't that. When I was a kid, we had what was called a hatchback, and I loved it. You could put the seat down, and you could get into the trunk. Now, the trunk was closed in my parents' defense, but I do understand how maybe something like that could happen. You know, people do have that.
And kids are squirrely. They move around when they're in the back, and they're in the hatchback, and then it looks like they're in the trunk, but you didn't put them in the trunk.
You said a name. I didn't recognize it. Is this a famous person, or just a regular person?
She's okay,
regular.
Yeah, just a regular old mom. Well, this is, wow. They say that dogs are a man's best friend, but I'm not sure that this dog was this man's best friend. A man in Germany suffered a horrifying ordeal this week when his dog bit off his manhood and ate it.
What?
Oh, my gosh.
His dog thought it was sausages?
I don't know what happened. I don't know how the dog got access. I don't know what you were doing with your dog.
That's what I wonder, too. I mean, I'm just trying to think if... Okay, you have to be naked, first of all.
Yeah.
Then you have to, the dog's gonna leap at you, grab it, and then tussle it off.
How did this all go down? I don't know if he was celebrating National Peanut Butter Lovers Day early.
Too bad we can't interview the dog.
Is this on the up and up, or did the dog just have a bad day?
I'd like to know, because, you would say, why would your dog just go off out of nowhere? I mean, first of all, you know, if one of the three dogs around my house did that, look, I got my pants on. I can't say I'm ever really naked in front of the dogs. It just feels weird to me.
Well, you can't fault him for that. If you're walking around your house naked and your dog is there.
But the dog just out of nowhere just latched on?
Let me just say, I was always naked around Chewy, and he never tried to leap or snarl.
I've never heard about that.
I don't don't know if I'm buying all that whole thing.
How did this all go down? The man is in serious condition. They say he will pull through, but I don't know what's going to happen with the relationship between he and his dog because
it's over.
I think it's changed.
It's over.
Right?
It's definitely.
I mean, is there any going back when that happens?
We need to rehome the dog.
That is kind of. There are people.
Maybe
who,
for the dog's sake, we need to rehome it.
Yeah.
There are people who have dogs. They love their dog, but gosh, their dog hates them, and that it hurts the owner's heart because they want the dog to love them so much. Not all dogs are the lover or the friend of the owner.
They say that's the problem. Like Joe Manganiello and Sofia Vergara. Broke up because his dog hated her.
Really? Oh, wow.
I dated a girl who her dog hated her so bad, and she was in such denial about the dog hating her.
Aww.
And she loved her dog
so
much.
Tough.
She tried to pet the dog, would snarl and try to bite her, but only her. And she was the owner.
Oh, no way.
And she was so nice.
Oh, wow. I don't know if I've ever seen that. It's terrible. It hurts your heart, doesn't it?
It does.
Hurts your heart. Virginia, did you see the update on the Epstein grand jury testimony?
I did. So we get some kind of information this summer.
That's kind of what's...
We have to wait until like June?
Going down, yeah. So is it a big deal? Is it a nothing burger? I'll break it all down for you coming up next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Donald Trump's motorcade has moved northbound out of Palm Beach County on I-95 northbound. Those rolling roadblocks continue, though, heading up to Orange Avenue in Fort Pierce. If you are traveling in that direction, you can expect fairly heavy delays on 95 this morning. There's also an incident that's causing delays on 95 southbound. This one before the exit for Belvedere Road has a right lane blocked. Expect heavy delays on the approach to that area. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
This is the day of the big sale at your gift shop.
Welcome in.
So this isn't just a big day for your business. It's a big day for the network keeping it all connected. That is, if it can handle the pressure.
Next in line, please.
So is it possible to get business internet you can really count on? It is. With 99.9% network reliability from Comcast Business. It's like this neat little bow.
Do you like that gift wrap?
Really ties it all together. Reliable internet for your business. It's not just possible. It's happening. Comcast Business. Powering possibilities.
Get started with internet and security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get an $800 prepaid card on a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call or go online today to switch to Comcast Business. Ends 5/5/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Eco bill and auto pay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medication called Revelex. It's proven to work. You've probably heard about semaglutide. It's got all the celebrity buzz, and it's FDA approved for weight loss. Well, Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide meds, and it comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. And you're not going to be waiting to fill your prescription. There's no back orders. Get started on Revelex today, and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs, all while eating a wide variety of foods. You can still enjoy cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Plus, Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts, so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. So schedule your appointment to get started on Revelex today. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
Starting with one store in 1978, Boot Barn has become the largest Western and workwear retailer in the nation. Supporting those who feed, build, and protect America, we offer the largest selection of cowboy boots, work boots, Western wear, workwear, and outdoor gear. With over 500,000 pairs of boots and thousands of top quality jeans and clothing, it's an honor to support the people who make our country so great. Boot Barn. Keep West.
I can't wait to go back to Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach next week. I'm doing my next PRP infusion, and it really is amazing. Roberto, that did my first treatment, he was showing me on his own scalp. Okay, this is my before picture, and now look at my after. At Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach, they are regrowing hair. I saw it on his scalp right there in front of me. This transdermal infusion of advanced PRP is so technologically advanced. It's amazing, it works, and it's even regrowing hair for alopecia patients. If you're balding, if your hair is breaking and thinning, maybe you've lost the thickness and your ponytail is like half the size and you're panicking, go see my friends at Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach and get that thick, beautiful, luxurious hair back. You can do it. Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach. Call 561-318-7284.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
Hey, it's Jay Bird. If you are hungry like a hippo, like I am, Dunkin's got you covered. Let's start the Friday off with some donuts in your belly. And let's not forget, too, Dunkin' cards. They're a great present for the Dunkin' fans out there. If you've got a family member that you love, give them a Dunkin' card. Put some money on that thing. They're going to be happy. Oh, so happy. Don't forget, too, DD Perks membership. You're going to get deals galore, reward points. That's how you get all the fun stuff, like me and the Sinickies. I am Jay Bird, and I run on Dunkin'.
Experience the Anna Jar Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Well, there was an announcement made about the grand jury testimony in Jeffrey Epstein's 2006 sexual abuse case that had happened. And they want to know what the heck was going on, because he got this sweetheart of a deal that he shouldn't have received.
No one should receive this sweet of a deal where you go, you're allowed to leave and go out of the jail and go work, and then you have to come back and check yourself in and out of jail.
It was insane. Yeah, he was sentenced to 18 months in jail, which turned out to be 13 months. He spent 6 days a week, 12 hours a day on work release. So he's just hanging out wherever he wants. And more than one woman said that she was flown in for sex at his newly formed company where he worked during the day. So
while he was sentenced,
he's
got this sentence. He lets himself out during the day to go to work, and he's surrounded by women at the workplace that he hires to be there, and then flies in. New tale.
It's unbelievable. So yeah, people are like, how did he get that deal? This has got to be all about money and power. Which, what, justice is supposed to be blind, right? Everybody gets treated the same.
You are actually sounding dumb right now, because justice is not blind.
I'll have to call Kevin dumb.
Sorry.
That's a little harsh.
I think you're very smart, Kevin.
Thank you. So our governor, Ron DeSantis, he was at the Palm Beach Police Department yesterday signing a bill passed by the state legislature last week authorizing the release of the grand jury testimony, and this is what the governor had to say yesterday.
The reality is the investigation was largely stymied because you didn't have access to the grand jury materials. And so, but I think the legislature and I agreed that, you know, there needs to be a mechanism in some of these rare circumstances where people can get the truth and where we can try to pursue justice.
Okay.
Yes.
Justice is going to be a slight bit delayed because the documents cannot come out until July 1st. And then right after the announcement was made, a circuit court judge said, yeah, I'm not going to be releasing those early. And somebody still has to petition a judge to get the documents released. So there's still some work that they have to do to even get that.
They're still protecting each other because they know either their names or one of their boys' names are on the list.
Well, here's the thing. I don't think it's anything. I think it's all a nothing burger. I don't even think you should pay attention to this story. I don't think it matters because an attorney for several of the Epstein victims, he doesn't even think there's going to be anything of consequence to come out of it, even when we get it in July. He said, I bet you there's going to be very little that was given to this grand jury, which is why the charges that came out of the grand jury were also pretty minimal. He didn't think that they got anything. So the question is, I think you're looking in the wrong place. Somebody withheld more evidence and damning information that could have gotten a bigger sentence to Jeffrey Epstein. So it's not in the grand jury testimony because they didn't get it in the first place.
Why is a lot of it redacted, though?
You have to talk to the attorney, but he thinks it's a nothing burger. And honestly, this wild goose chase we've been on, I kind of agree with him. I don't think much is going to come out of it.
Who's got this damn list of all the clients? There is a list. There was a book.
It's a shell game. It's like, a shell game.
Put Acosta on one of those when you tell a lie, it zaps you in the butt kind of chairs.
Mm-hmm.
Put Acosta on that so we can figure out why the sweetheart deal was so sweet.
Do they make those chairs, or that's something you made up in your own mind? It zaps your butt if you're lying?
Yeah, like a lie detector, but have it like wired up like an electric chair. And every time you lie, it gives you a zolt.
Okay, so you did make it up in your own head.
I did.
Okay, got you.
But I want it hooked up to like the undercarriage.
Okay, that's your strategy?
Yeah.
You think that's how we're going to get this information?
Start with Acosta, put him on the seat, and let's see what happens.
They say those lie detector tests of any sort are not accurate at all. You could be telling the truth, not have murdered anybody, and still fail any kind of lying test. How does that make you think? Hello, guys?
I don't know. I just feel like it's so ridiculous that here we are, still don't have a single John's name. Still don't have a single guy that is a pedophile's name.
Well, the one thing that DeSantis did do yesterday, of course, making it political, he did say after signing the bill that he thinks the president, Joe Biden, should release the federal file on Epstein. So he put a challenge out there as well to say, okay, we're doing this here in Florida. Let's go on ahead and get the federal government to make a stand as well. So go on ahead.
Shouldn't we release every file?
Including UFO files. I agree with the witch on that. Virginia, yes.
Yeah.
I just want all the files to be out there so we can know who the criminals are and put them in jail.
Yeah. Okay, so that's what it is. Unfortunately, I don't think it's anything. I do see what that attorney's saying. So the grand jury might not have gotten anything in the first place. I guess we'll find out, hopefully, sometime in July. Is it possible that other moms think that Virginia is insane? She had an experience at the park, and she thinks that maybe this mom looked at her like she might have been crazy. What did she say to get that look? You'll find out next.
Forget about the world.
This just in. We've got late breaking news here. Remember Kathy earlier who went to the art thrift store in Lake Worth Beach?
Yes.
And she found a piece of art for $3,900 and she was so pissed she walked out and then went to another thrift store a bit south and their pieces were awful and she walked out and now she's done with thrifting.
So it was too expensive at the first place, didn't have the good pieces at the second place, and now the spirit is broken.
And now it's ruined her entire life of thrifting. It's over. It's done.
Weekend ruined.
Yeah. We do have a rebuttal and a response to Kathy here from next door. This is April, and I work for the ARC, and I would like to respond to Kathy's comment from next door. Our thrift store in Lake Worth has great deals and an amazing selection, and all proceeds go towards supporting children and adults with disabilities. Some of the artwork that is donated is worth thousands of dollars. Those exceptional pieces are meant to raise that much more money for our programs and equipment. We also have artwork that is sold at a higher price because eight or more of our clients may work on a piece for several months and they're able to earn a paycheck from selling the place. So we are a nonprofit. We feel the call out was out of context, Kathy. We love the KBJ show, by the way, so please come and visit our thrift store. So there you go. Just because Kathy is done with the ARC thrift store in Lake Worth Beach doesn't mean you should be.
That is...
Yeah. That's the kind of drama you get started by next door. That's why you can see why I'm so addicted to it. It's a bunch of... It's nonsensical. It means nothing. There's just absolutely no substance on there, but my gosh, I can't stop the soap opera.
The things people complain about.
It's unreal. That's what it's like all day long.
Sometimes I'll even get an email just about the show. It'll be something like, Kevin's shirt was wrinkled for 15 minutes today, and it didn't get fixed. Like, wait, what?
It's all that nonstop. I just can't, I can't believe that people are like, they have to. That Kathy raced right home and ran right the next door. It's like, oh, thrifting. It's ruined.
If you surf on social media, you'll find no shortage of that kind of stuff.
I'm hooked. It's like my terrible, like, Virginia, you love those terrible reality shows?
I do.
I get it now. I finally do. It's just terrible. I can't stop the drama.
This is your drama. This is your Housewives.
Gosh. I think a lot of people
love
watching or reading drama as long as it doesn't involve them.
Yeah. I just love Kathy's post. I couldn't believe it. It's just her joy of thrifting is over now. Gosh, that's got to be tough. Virginia, you think other moms might think you're insane?
Yeah, I think sometimes I'm not self-aware, and I'm just, I say stuff, and then I regret it after, and I'm like, oh, I probably shouldn't have said that.
Finally, this is good, though. You're seeing the light.
Well, I said something really, I mean, I didn't think it was that bad when I said it, but then now in hindsight, I guess it wasn't that nice, but... I was at the park yesterday with Rocco, and he loves going to the park and playing, but he's running all over, and I'm kind of sitting on a little, like a picnic table by myself under the shade, doing a little work on my phone.
You weren't feeding the birds, were you?
No. I was getting stuff done on my phone, and this mom was sitting like maybe, I don't know, 15 feet from me, and she was talking to her kid, but I wasn't paying attention.
Okay.
And so when the kid... scooted off on her little scooter, the mom turned to me and goes, oh, did you hear that pitch? Can you believe that? I'm not going to get that. And I was like, I didn't hear it. I wasn't paying attention. Okay. But I was like, oh, no, what'd she say? And the mom goes, well, she was trying to pitch me on getting her an electric scooter because she's got a kick scooter, you know, the kind that you have to do the work with your foot.
Yes.
Other kids were there at the park and they had the electric ones, vroom, 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 that you don't have to kick. And I said, well, I mean, just tell her, look, those other kids are going to be doughy, and she's going to be in great shape. You don't need an electric scooter. You're gonna keep it high and tight. You got a kick scooter. And the mom was like, oh, my God. She put her head down and did not speak to me again.
I looked up.
So, wait, you said it, and then you looked at her face, and, like, what?
She made a noise and goes, oh, and looked down.
I've heard people make those noises before when Virginia said something. Like, oh.
I mean, I wasn't calling that other kid doughy. I was just giving her something to say to her daughter to, like, reinforce her point. Like, no, you're not getting an electric scooter. You're going to use a kick scooter, and it's going to be better for you because you're exercising while you're out here, and you're not going to be doughy like that other kid. But I didn't even know what that other kid looked like. Turns out that other kid was kind of doughy. And I didn't know that when I said that. I wasn't trying to call out that doughy kid. I was just trying to reinforce her argument with her daughter.
Right.
Oh, boy.
She just didn't think that you'd be calling another kid doughy.
I think she thought I was just insane.
It's more insulting if it's a specific kid you're going after. Like, that kid is doughy.
Yeah.
If you're just making the blanket statement, you're going to be doughy if you're not extra. That's what you're saying.
That's what I was trying to say. It might have come out wrong.
She painted one kid with the doughy brush.
I did. But I didn't even see that kid. I didn't realize I was.
That woman was throwing out a little fishing line. She wanted a friend. She wanted to see if you were friend material. The best thing happened. She's too soft to hang out with you.
Oh my gosh! Yeah, we cannot hang out.
That's Virginia behaving and being cool.
That's Virginia in her natural habitat.
I don't fit in with the other moms at the park, and maybe next time I got to sit further away so nobody engages. Because I'm just gonna say something rude, and they're gonna be disgusted.
Would that mom be at a 10-hour Sunday brunch?
No.
That's what I'm saying. You got to get with the moms that can hang with you. Yeah. You can't be with one of them soccer moms that, oh, my gosh.
I need pirate moms.
Yes.
Viking moms.
Right.
Feral moms.
They are out there.
Give me those. Those are my moms.
I think you're going to find them at the park, though.
No, they're not at the park. They're at the bar.
You're going to find them at the bar.
They're at the places that are like a bar/restaurant.
Yeah. Oh, she was so fishy to be your friend. And then she's like, I don't like this woman.
She couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
The regret so quick on her face from engaging with me.
Oh. Coming up here in a couple of minutes. Why does everyone want out of Florida? I actually have an answer for you. Coming up next.
KVJ is on TikTok. And, well, let's just say interesting. At KVJ Show. So follow us. More KVJ next on 97.9 WRMF.
It's a groovable feast at Universal Mardi Gras, February 3rd through April 7th. Enjoy the international flavors of Carnival with an ice-cold Coca-Cola Zero Sugar at the hottest party in town. This is your bee-throwing, concert-going, non-stop festival of fun.
Florida residents, get 2 days free when you buy a two-park, one-day park-to-park ticket. Dig into the details at UniversalOrlando.com. Not available at front gate. Used by 6/26/24. Restrictions apply.
Z-O-O-M-T-A-N. I was tan last summer, now I'm pale again. I need a little bit of help to be ready for the beach. Zoom tan puts some within my reach. Brown as a biscuit for $9.99. ZoomTan.com for a limited time.
Zoom tan, $9.99. Zoom tan.
All copper tans are now Zoom tans. Go to ZoomTan.com/radio for $9.99 offer.
Strax Aesthetics, the foremost name in cosmetic surgery, is now offering unbelievable pricing for tax season. Breast augs from under $100 per month, tummy tucks from under $200 per month, and gastric sleeves for excess weight loss as low as $300 per month for qualified patients. All surgeries are performed by renowned board-certified surgeons. Strax guarantees to beat any quote by comparable surgeons, and Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price for services. View surgeon bios and past work by visiting StraxPlastic.com or call 954-749-3040 for a free consultation.
Tis the month of St. Patty's Day. Aren't you just a wee bit curious to see how ZipRecruiter can help you? Well, today's your lucky day, because you can try ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/Bob. In fact, 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Once again, just go to this exclusive web address to try ZipRecruiter for free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/Bob. ZipRecruiter. The smartest way to hire.
When it comes to choosing a health plan, you can trust the members who have experienced it firsthand. Humana is proud to offer a Medicare Advantage plan in Florida that earned 5 out of 5 stars. 5 stars is the highest rating possible. It's based on real members' experiences, and it's decided by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. Our Humana Gold Plus HMO earned 5 out of 5 stars. That means a few things. It means members get outstanding customer service. It means we connect them with excellent preventive care and chronic condition support. Most of all, it means you have a trustworthy option for a Medicare Advantage plan. Explore our 5-star Humana Gold Plus HMO at humana5star.com. Humana, a more human way to healthcare. Every year, Medicare evaluates plans based on a 5-star rating system. Humana is a Medicare Advantage HMO organization with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in any Humana plan depends on contract renewal.
Well, hey, there's a lot of celebrities that are doing it. In fact, there's big news about Oprah today getting off the board at Weight Watchers because, you know what? She found the pharmaceuticals, and they're effective. They do work. And Wellington Anti-Aging has got them. So if you want to finally break from those diets that are not working for you or the exercise regimen that hasn't done a thing to help you shake the fat, I'm telling you, Wellington Anti-Aging has got the secret for you. You can lose that weight, get down to your ideal body weight, get into a healthier frame for you. Everything that is about anti-aging, they have. It's not just about taking off weight. As you get older, it gets tougher to do. They can balance out your hormones, too, which you're finding is so key. That does kickstart your metabolism. It helps your libido. If you're going through menopause, you can get rid of the hot flashes and the night sweats. And you can get more energy on top of it and even fend off long-term health complications like heart disease, type 2 diabetes, even some forms of cancer. Why are people living a better life at an older age? Because of places like Wellington Anti-Aging. So get your free consultation today online. It's WellingtonAntiAging.com. That's WellingtonAntiAging.com.
Mostly cloudy with areas of patchy fog, especially those inland spots. Otherwise, it is muggy. The few passing showers too possible this morning. Temperatures in the upper 60s throughout the morning. Heating up fast, though, into the low 80s this afternoon with partly to mostly cloudy skies. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
Sponsored by Compassion International.
We've all felt the impact of rising food prices. For families in poverty, they're facing malnutrition and even death. You can feed a family for a month with your $50 donation to Compassion International. Just text the word radio to 97646.
Wait, KVJ is on TikTok? Oh, you've got to see this. Now, back to the KVJ show on 97.9 WRMF.
So why is everybody wanting out of Florida? Saw that headline. I was like, wait, everybody wants out of Florida? What the heck is going on?
I thought everybody was coming to Florida.
Yeah, that's what confused me as well.
Well, the rich people are coming and everyone else is leaving.
I think you nailed it on the head, honestly, Bird. Mm. I think that's it. Because, yeah, it did surprise me, too. I'm like, wait a minute, who wants out of Florida? But there are numbers to back it up, and they're pretty convincing. Have you ever heard of Zillow?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, it's where you go and you list houses for sale and all that.
You can go on there and see, like, if your house was ever on there. It saves Zillow forever.
Oh, it does?
Yeah,
okay.
You can go back and find, like, three incarnations ago.
If I type in my house on Zillow, it'll take me back to three owners before me.
Oh, that's kind of
cool. Pictures that are on there.
It's wild to see how your house has changed since you've been in it.
Okay, yeah, I'm not really familiar with the site, but it is where you list houses. And Florida has more Zillow listings in general than the rest of the United States. Comparing it against big states like California and Texas and New York, we are still crushing them in the numbers. They say that, part of it might be because we've got not only residential properties, but we also have vacation properties. So that could inflate the number a bit. But the one that is more damning for this is what they call motivated sellers. And a motivated seller is somebody who will accept lower offers from potential home buyers to sell quickly. It's people that just want to get the heck out. Now, it could be because of financial loss, divorce, or separation. Of course, we have a lot of that in Florida. Job relocation or other personal issues. But they say they think there is one thing that is really driving this and why people want out of Florida. Property insurance increases.
That's a big thing. My mortgage has gone up a lot because the insurance has gone up.
Mine has gone up. Denny's has gone up. I mean, everyone's has gone up. Most people, everyone I talk to, they go, oh my gosh, the insurance is screwing me.
Hundreds and hundreds of dollars.
Oh, mine's gone up. But since I bought my house, which was only 3 years ago or 2.5 years ago, it's gone up at least $350.
Wow.
Yeah. Home insurance costs in the state of Florida have increased by 102% in the past 3 years, and they are three times more expensive than the national average. So why are people wanting to get out of Florida? Home insurance costs.
Oh, I was talking to one of my friends that lives in a different state up in the New Hampshire area, and I thought that was expensive, and they were telling me that it's cheaper up there. They're talking about how they had to leave Florida because of all those things you're talking about, the house insurance, even just to rent People are spending $2,500 a month to rent in a two-bedroom place.
Well, they say what's happening, it's the weird flip. Yeah, you do have the rich that are coming in and buying properties in cash. But remember how many retirees we had? We had the stigma, oh, Florida's where all the old people are. Retirees on fixed incomes can't deal with this home insurance price increase. And now it's driving retirees out of Florida.
Wow.
So will it ever go back down? When you say three times with everybody.
If it's gone up $350 a month, like it has for you, that's over $4,000 a year. Imagine you're on a fixed income.
Right.
You haven't budgeted for an extra $4,000 a year.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Now, hopefully there is some relief. Seven new insurance companies have been approved to start writing policies here in Florida, which hopefully will start driving down the price of home insurance. So maybe it will start going in the opposite direction. But right now you go onto Zillow and I think you'll be stunned with the numbers. And they say part of it too is, you know, we're at the highest home price appreciation over the past 3 years as well. So some people are just cashing out and saying, you know what, I like Florida, but all things considered with the home insurance rates and the fact that people are coming in with cash to buy and I can sell high right now and get the heck out and go to the Carolinas.
Because I work from home anyway, right, and it's a computer that I can plug in wherever.
So it's an interesting thing because we just think about, hey, all the people are coming to Florida. And yeah, rich people are. They're coming and they're buying people who are middle income or lower. And it's just like, bye, we're passing each other. It's like a two-lane highway. The rich are driving in and the other are driving out.
Am I the only one that ever gets scared not opening up the mail when it comes to that kind of stuff? I'm always going, they're going to tell me that my mortgage just went up $7,000. I just know it.
Yeah, you see, from, you know, whatever it might be, whatever company it is that deals with that, I think people do. You have PTSD.
Yeah,
you open it up and you're like,
first thing I do when I open up the mail, I look very down at the bottom to see if it says this is not a bill, just to make sure, because it can get confusing.
It's very stressful when you don't know how much money you're going to need to survive every month because it keeps going up, and there's nothing you can do about
it. It's like the restaurant Wendy's going up and down every single day. It's a different price for a burger.
Yeah.
You're right. People do not like being surprised when it comes to their finances.
Especially a mortgage. Like, that's your biggest nut usually.
Right. Yeah. So maybe look into that if you are dealing with it. Just maybe start shopping. A couple texts. One person said, Kin Insurance, K-I-N, is one of the new companies coming in. We shopped around enough, got a quote from them, and it was lower than last year. And we were getting quotes from State Farm and, you know, for like $6,000, but Kin Insurance did it for $2,000.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so just shop around. It's still a free market out there, thank God. And having seven new companies that are now approved to start writing business, you start shopping, comparing. I mean, imagine going from $6,000 to $2,000. That's a pretty good drop.
That is a significant drop.
Mm-hmm. So it is out there. Just start looking around. Well, one of the reasons why people love being in the state of Florida is for weekends like this, where you're going to have great weather, lots of sunshine, and you got so many amazing things to do all weekend. If you don't know what's going on, you will in just a couple minutes. I'll give you the full rundown coming up next here on the KVJ Show.
Once the flight had flown, with the wilt of the rose, I slept all alone, but you still wouldn't go. Let's fast forward to 300 takeout coffees later. I see your profile and your smile on unsuspecting waiters. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every maiden's bed for something greater, baby. Was it over? Down on your couch, was it over when he unbuttoned my blouse? Come here, I whispered in your ear in your dream as you passed out, baby. Was it over then? And is it over now? When you lost control, red blood, white snow. Dress on a bow. Your new girl is my clone. And did you think I didn't see there were flashing lights?
lights. At least I had the decency to keep my nights out of sight. Only rumors about my hips and thighs and my whispered sighs. Oh Lord, I think about jumping off a very tall somethings just to see you come running and say the one thing I've been wanting. But no, let's fast forward to 300 awkward blind dates later. If she's got blue eyes, I will surmise that she'll probably date her. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every model's bed for something greater, baby. Was it over when she laid down on your couch? Was it over when he unbuttoned my blouse? Come here, I whispered in your ear in your dream as you passed out, baby. Was it over then? And is it over now? Flashing lights. At least I had the decency to keep my nights out of sight. Only rumbles by my hips and thighs and I whispered sighs. Oh Lord, I think about jumping off a fairy tale somethings just to see you come running and say the one thing I've been wanting. But no.
Everything you want in an ideal South Florida weekend is going on. Lots of sunshine, pretty low rain chances, maybe about 20%. Sunday's the only day that maybe you might get a little bit of it. It's only 40% chance of rain on Sunday. Looks really nice. And there's so many great things going on, especially outdoor activities. Spring training is going on in its second weekend. Today, if you go out, catch out some baseball. You got the Astros Nationals, a ballpark at the Palm Beaches, Mets Cards playing at Roger Dean, and the Yankees, Bird, your favorite team, are playing the Cardinals at Roger Dean Stadium.
They're not my least favorite team anymore. The Yankees.
Okay. All right.
It's the Astros.
Oh, okay, the Astros. Okay, we can get them at Ballpark at the Palm Beaches. So they're all here today for you. Of course, the Cognizant Classic is going on at PGA National. It is round two going on today. And I would imagine they want to see one of the stars, either Rory McIlroy or Ricky Fowler, do really well. Right now, Chad Ramey and S.H. Kim are tied for
who?
First place. Yeah.
They want a big name.
They do. Now, Rory's kind of in it. He had a pretty good round yesterday, 4 under. He's tied for 16th place. So he's just 3 off of the leader. So that is doable. Ricky Fowler is even. He's 7 off, but he's in 95th place. And the reason why you pay attention to that, they do have a cut after today.
Oh.
And you don't want to see like a Ricky Fowler get cut because then there's one less marquee name that yeah. is going to be around for the weekend.
Who's the Tiger Woods currently?
The dude. Who's the guy right now? Is there a number one guy?
Yeah, there is. I'm not sure what the rankings are. I mean, Rory's number two in the world.
So Rory would be the cachet.
Yeah, it might be
name.
John Rahm. Okay. And he's going to be playing in that live event in April.
They got the rom-com. Got it. Yeah.
You have Ricky Fowler. He is already out there today. He teed off at 7:40. Rory McIlroy is going to be teeing off at 12:40 today in the Cognizant Classic. Other things going on this weekend. There's some good outdoor stuff that is going to be happening as well. Rib Roundup is going to be awesome tomorrow at I Think Financial Amphitheater. I am psyched. Ribs and country music. Lainey Wilson is one of the big names out there, and she is going to be the headliner. I saw her in November in Miami at that Country Bay Music Festival, and this girl is good. She got a strong voice and a lot of hits as well. There she is with the old Jelly Roll. I'm so never say never with you. I end up together with you. It's hell and it's heaven. Nate Smith, Warren Zeiders, Rodney Atkins also going to be out there performing this weekend. Danny's got to be pumped because he picked it as one of the best South Florida events. The Renaissance Festival is going on again this weekend.
We got to get out there one of these days.
It screams your thing.
Put a little baby Lachlan in a dragon costume and go out there.
Yeah. I want to go, though, dressed as aliens from a different dimension and kind of just stir it up a little bit.
Oh, man. Yeah, they may not appreciate that.
Or they may love it.
Oh,
battle.
Think so?
Battle.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Lasers versus...
Knight versus alien.
That's exactly it. So. They might like it.
Guys, I want a video of that.
Maybe that's where you go and find your wife.
You got to bring a crew, though. You bring, you know, three or four alien creatures. We're here to take over your festival.
Oh, that'd be so awesome. I really would love to see that. That's going to be at Quiet Waters Park in Deerfield Beach all weekend long. You've also got some other stuff going on. Inter Miami is going to be home with Lionel Messi playing Orlando City Sunday night at Chase Stadium in Fort Lauderdale. If you want to go outside and see that. Polo, of course, is going on Sunday at the National Polo Center in Wellington. You can check that out. You've got the Maple Bacon Coffee Porter Festival, Funky Buddha Brewery in Oakland Park tomorrow.
Fun.
Yeah, if you like the craft beer stuff, that is going to be a really good time. There's also some live music. The Eagles are playing Hard Rock Live tonight and tomorrow. Bob Dylan's got the Broward Center tonight and tomorrow. And Bird, you might enjoy this event. It's the Montreux Jazz Festival, Miami. So they're taking the Montreux concept. They're bringing it to Miami. It's got John Batiste, Daryl Hall.
Okay.
From Hall & Oates.
I love John Batiste.
And Emily Estefan, Gloria's daughter, is going to be performing. It's going to be at the Hangar at Regatta Harbor in Coconut Grove. That is going on today through Sunday.
Go there when Daryl Hall starts singing, "Hey, where is Oates?"
See how long before you get kicked out. They're also doing the Festival of the Arts Boca at Meisner Park Amphitheater. Check out some movies there for the next 10 days. Cirque du Soleil doing Echo at Gulfstream Park in Hallandale Beach. St. Lucie County Fair is wrapping up this weekend on Midway Road in Fort Pierce. And that is just a smidge of all the stuff going on. We got all the events posted at kbjshow.com. You can go and check out everything that is happening this weekend right there. All right, do you have a nice, fun win for the week? You can let us know. Love to hear your feel-good Fridays. Text them in to us right now, 877-979-WRMF.
The KVJ Show will be right back. 97.9 WRMF.
Hey, West Palm Beach. Looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port-in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit pbia.org for more info.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
When you hire the guys from Cooling Advisors to stay on top of your AC, this is the team that's going to come out and jump when you call. The Cooling Club puts you in the level of VIP service that you expect and you need. When your AC is struggling, you want the team from Cooling Advisors to jump into action. And that's what they do when you're in the Cooling Club with them like I am. It also gets you regular service of your equipment. That'll save you thousands of dollars in energy costs over the years. It can be as much as 30% savings every year on energy cost. We love that. And you prolong the life of your system with regular scheduled maintenance and tune-ups and keeping an eye on it. I love that. The Cooling Advisors team is family-owned and operated. Been doing this now for 70 years. They know their stuff inside and out. It's the company you can trust. They background screen and drug test all of their employees. So go to CoolingAdvisors.com.
Quitting tobacco isn't easy. The good news is, Tobacco Free Florida is here to help you quit your way. Tobacco Free Florida's group quit service offers free virtual and in-person sessions at convenient times and locations. You may be eligible to receive free nicotine replacement therapy like patches, gum, or lozenges. You are not alone. Whatever your reason to quit is, Tobacco Free Florida can help you get started. Call 1-877-YOU-CAN-NOW.
Dollars, cash, greenbacks, however you say money, you're going to save thousands during the President's Day sales event going on right now at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Nick Rivers, right now, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, bring in any trade and get up to a $5,000 discount off any select new Kia in stock. Take home a sporty new 2024 Kia Forte for only $219 a month, 24-month lease with $2,799 due at signing. Or get 0.9% APR financing on the new 23 Kia Sorentos. You worried about your credit? Get pre-qualified online without affecting your credit score at GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. Save thousands during the President's Day sales event at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS. Follow them on Facebook. Online anytime. GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. And remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Qualified applicants through KMF. 10,000 miles per year. Security deposit waive zero down. $24.96 per 1,000 financed for 48 months at 0.9% APR financing. Plus tax tag and $9.99 admin fee. Negative equity refinanced. Offers don't combine. Expires March 5th.
I love my Dunkin' oh so much, and if you are like me, today would be a good day to get some of those stuffed bagel minis in your belly. Oh yeah, I love them. Now, if you're like my dad, he loves the wake-up wrap. That's right, you heard it here. Randy Pennington loves wake-up wraps from Dunkin', and don't sleep on that snack and bacon. It is delicious. I'm putting up a picture right now. It's so good. I am Jay Bird, and I run on Dunkin'.
Experience the Anna Jar Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
Don't forget the After the Show podcast, coming up live and uncensored. Get it wherever you get your podcasts. Now more of the KVJ Show on 97.9
WRMF. I always love to hear your little wins that you've got for the week. Feel Good Friday, a little positive news that we can all drink in and go for. One text says, I get to take my girlfriend to her first Renaissance Festival this weekend. Okay, aww. Look at that. Quiet Waters Park in Deerfield.
Very nice. I hope you're dressing up.
One person texts in, too. They said, I go to RenFest every Saturday. It's a blast, and dressing as an alien will be just fine.
I knew it would be. They would want. They want the dorkiness.
They have RenFest every Saturday?
It's a way of life, dog.
Yeah, well, it goes, yeah. I mean, there's a period. It has a season.
Oh.
Yeah, so it goes on for a while.
Tequesta don't.
She don't get out.
She don't know about this stuff.
You got a couple weeks. It goes to, like, I think, like, the last weekend in March.
I mean, you really could get very involved in this. You could, because I know Panda, your husband's got that Batman costume. Show up there in your Batman costume.
Oh, all of it, yeah.
Oh my gosh, there's so many ideas.
That thing is not breathable. It's like made out of rubber.
It's a
perfect for our climate.
You put it on and you are immediately covered in sweat.
The first thing you see when you look at this Batman costume is you go, that wasn't cheap.
Yeah. You can tell. This Feel Good Friday, first time in 5 years, my hubby and I are going to have two consecutive days alone without any of our four kids. We're going to beachside camping and I am ecstatic.
Wow.
Yeah. Just
make sure you don't get that fifth kid.
Yeah, girl.
And Jackie said, I am going to be picking up this guy tomorrow to join our family. It is a puppy.
My gosh.
Look how cute.
How adorable is
I just want to kiss
like
his snout.
Or something like that. Oh, it's a beautiful dog.
I don't know. It's adorable.
So cute.
Absolutely adorable. There you go. So you guys got some good weekends all set up for you. And I got a great idea for you to kick it all off. Jaybird will give you a thought for the day. Coming up next right here on the KBJ Show.
Well, you done me and you bet I felt it. I tried to beat you, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest. And nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate. Tongue in the mirror and bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanities and just go with the seasons. It's what we aim to do. Our name is our virtue. But I won't hesitate no more. No more, it cannot wait. I'm yours. Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you'll find that the sky is yours. So please don't, please don't, please don't. There's no need here to complicate. Cause our time is short. This, oh, this, oh, this is our fate.
We got the app of the show going to be coming up here live on YouTube. Also, you can get it on Twitch, or you can also just wait and get it on your podcast, wherever you do those, like Spotify. Before we get to that, though, Bird's going to wrap us all up here with his thought for the day.
Real quick, too, if you go to our YouTube KVJ page, the Weird Whatever is up there. It's 55 minutes long, but
nice.
We did have a technical difficulty, so the last 5 minutes got cut off. But
you trip on the cord again.
Dog, if you only knew. All right, let's get positive. Love. Talked a lot about love. Love is the whole thing. We are only the pieces.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think Virginia wants to be a piece of the love pie.
That's supposed to get me through the weekend?
You need therapy. That's what you need.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.